You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
In the year 2003, a very popular Japanese fan manga was established and created by an individual that goes by the name of Toible, who at the time was an up-and-coming Dragon Ball fan manga artist that we all know today as Toyotaro. And ever since the creation of Dragon Ball AF by Toible in 2003, Toible had left off his Dragon Ball fan manga incomplete by having Zycor finally break out of the Z Sword in confronting the Z Fighters for one last battle. And although the fan manga at the time till this day has been discontinued, we have taken it upon ourselves in continuing the original story of Toible's Dragon Ball AF by not only staying true to the original story of Zycor, but also including a brand new vision of our own that features the likes of many inclusions and characters in the story. But the million-dollar question going forward is, with the story of Zycor continuing and with Zycor being who he is it possible for Zycor to be stopped by any one of our heroes by themselves, or will Zycor follow through with his plan in doing what he was set out to do once he had arrived on planet Earth? Now, before we dive any further into this video, if you are new to the channel and of course have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime related, and want to be kept up to date with everything in regards to Dragon Ball, the Dragon Ball Super manga, and everything involving the Dragon Ball IP, then I do encourage you guys to go on over and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single video on this channel, as well as giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply stoked, ready, and excited to see what the future holds in regards to the Dragon Ball franchise. And with all that being said, I want to thank you all so much for your support, and let's dive straight into the video. As we kick off the Beyond Dragon Ball AF Story of Zycor's Revenge manga chapter number 1 special, with Zycor shown having to finally be freed from the Z Sword in which he was sealed in, there is no question that Zycor is seeking to get revenge on those who had sealed him off for many months now. And with Zycor shown having to stare at his hands, he then went along to comment, "My body, I'm freed. How long was I sealed away for? Curse those disgusting creatures and their cheap tricks." As he then further went along to power up, Zycor then continues, "How dare you imprison a god! Your acts of rebellion will be paid." And with Krillin, Vegeta, and Trunks looking on, Trunks further added by commenting, "What in the world? His power? It's mind-boggling." With Krillin chiming in, "What terrifying energy. In all my years of doing this, I've never felt anything like this guy before. What do we do now?" And with Vegeta casually having to approach Zycor, he then addressed everyone by telling them, "Stand aside. I'll take care of this myself. If all else, I need you to remain where you are in case you both are needed. Which I doubt." And with Zycor still shown having to stare at his hands, he then comments, "My power seems to remain intact. I will crush each and every single one of them for what they've done." But then, as soon as Vegeta finally approaches Zycor, he then went along to address Zycor by telling him, "So, you're still alive. And here I'd thought you'd break out of that sword a lot sooner than you did. So much for being the mightiest life form, huh? Well then, this is where it ends. For you, that is. I haven't forgotten about what you've done to me, so don't assume you're going to be skipping over me to fight the others. I've got some unfinished business to settle with you, hybrid. Now what's it going to be? Shall I beat you into submission, or blast you into a million pieces? Your move." With Zycor responding, "Ah, Vegeta, still as prideful as before. I assume you still haven't learned your lesson from before. I am going to enjoy having you as my first victim since being released. I hope you're ready for the beating you have coming. I can see that nothing's really changed with you, so I'm going to enjoy turning you into my first victim along with your pathetic friends. But that's when Vegeta went along to point out behind him by telling Zycor, they have nothing to do with any of this, Zycor. They're just here to watch the fireworks, so therefore, you will not do anything to harm them. What? Says Zycor. Who'd said I'd be taking orders from you, Vegeta? Once I'm done tossing you into the trash, I am going to take my sweet time in killing your friends one by one. That's assuming that you'd even get past me to begin with, says Vegeta. I'm not the same fighter I was before when I fought you, so this fight isn't going to be the same as it was. You're bluffing, says Zycor. Nothing's changed. Then allow me to show you, says Vegeta. As Vegeta then begins to transform ever so, as he's doing this, Zycor went along to turn his head and noticing two individuals on top of a cliff, with Zycor asking himself, more of them? And who are they? The bigger one. He's a Saiyan. I sense a deep power hidden within him. I've never seen him before, but somehow, his power feels familiar to me. More cattle to be slaughtered. And the other? These warriors are not from this planet. With Vegeta then transforming back into Super Saiyan 4, he then addresses Zycor by telling him, now then, I hope you're ready to finally meet your end, because this will not be as easy as you thought it was before. Now what's it going to be? With Zycor responding and sticking his hand out by telling Vegeta, you are no threat to me, Vegeta. But that's when Vegeta went along to teleport right behind Zycor and telling him, I wouldn't be so cocky if I were you. How did he just, as Vegeta proceeded to kick Zycor right across the neck by then telling him, it would be in your best interest if you paid attention and fight me using everything you have. And with Zycor attempting to fight back by swinging at Vegeta, he then went along to ask him, you think this power of yours is going to be the key in defeating me, Vegeta? You tried this before and you lost. As Vegeta then went along to uppercut Zycor by then telling him, our battle before means nothing at the face of what's happening now, fool. Did you really think I was going to stand around and wait for you to emerge without training? I was preparing myself for the day you were released, so that I could finally turn your lights off for good after what you've done. And with Vegeta continuously shown beating on Zycor, he then continues, you are no Saiyan, you are a cheap carbon copy who's living a lie. You could never know the true power of a real Saiyan. We are the embodiment of the Saiyan race, and you are not. Which, interestingly enough, as Vegeta is shown putting a beating on Zycor, Broly is shown observing from the cliff and having to stare down very intensely at this battle, and with Vegeta shown beating on Zycor, he then continues, you were made in a lab, put together to imitate our people and to use a power that isn't even yours. Not to mention stealing the power of that clown Kakarot, nonetheless. I won't be wasting my time in letting you get away with smearing the Saiyan's name, you abomination. You could never understand a warrior spirit, because you weren't there to experience a Saiyan's resolve. There is no scenario where you walk away with your life. As Vegeta proceeds to kick Zycor away, Zycor stumbles on back by having to respond, cocky little worm. How did you get this strong within such a short time span? Invisibly having to cling onto his stomach, as of course Trunks and Krillin look on, Krillin then went along to ask Trunks, what do you think, Trunks? I think Father's got the edge over him, but something's off, says Trunks. And with Vegeta attempting to punch Zycor once again, what Zycor followed up by doing was grabbing onto Vegeta's punch by then telling him, well played, Vegeta. It looks as though you may have exceeded me temporarily. But you still can't beat me. But Vegeta is not having it, because even as Zycor is shown having to clinch onto Vegeta's fist, what Vegeta does as a retaliatory attack is he ends up sticking out his right arm and blasting Zycor from point blank range by telling him, I'm tired of listening to you speak. To the afterlife with you, it's over. And because of this, Vegeta had blasted Zycor with what he thought was possibly a strong enough attack that was going to rend Zycor obsolete, and with everyone observing including PyCon, PyCon went on to utter, something's not right. Vegeta didn't do it. And with Vegeta shown huffing and puffing, he then comments, good riddance. But then, through the smoke, we then see how Zycor is slowly stepping out and walking towards Vegeta. Zycor then went along to address Vegeta by telling him, that attack of yours actually hurts. Well played, Vegeta. I must admit, you've grown much stronger than how you were before, and in such a short time too. However, it was as I had told you, you can't win. Did you forget that I'm part Saiyan too? I can adapt to my foe just like you, which means my growth is inevitable. Need I remind you again, Goku's blood runs through my body, which means this is not the limit of my power. I am more than just a Saiyan. I am a god, born with the body of a warrior and the power of a deity. Did you actually buy into your own garbage, Saiyan? How pathetic, and with Vegeta looking on, he then went along to ask, how is he not damaged? He's acting as though nothing even happened just now, with Zycor continuing, if Super Saiyan 4 is the best you can do, then you are doomed, Vegeta. Once I kill you, I will then go on to destroy the rest of your friends and family, before finally finding and destroying the worm known as Goku. The only useful thing about your power is that it's only strong enough to keep you alive a little longer than I hoped for. You think this is going to be that easy? Vegeta asks. Of course I do, Zycor responds, as he then proceeds to stick his arms out. Such is my design, Vegeta. I am beyond your Super Saiyan 4. My body cannot be broken, and it will be used to destroy you all by the end. With, of course, Zycor having to pound on his chest, Vegeta follows through by doing the exact same thing by responding, then in that case, I will be the one to smash that body of yours into pieces and end your life. Then by all means try, Vegeta, says Zycor, and that's exactly what Vegeta does, because as soon as Vegeta then goes on in attempting to attack Zycor, he then tells him, you're going to regret ever coming to this planet. No, Vegeta, says Zycor, I'm not, as he then backhands Vegeta so hard that Vegeta's body went flying into a nearby mountain, and with Zycor looking on, he then went along to comment, it's been a while since I was able to put this body into good use, and you will no doubt be the perfect warm-up. Now, since you're so eager to die, then let me be the one to make your death wish finally come true. So, what's it going to be, Saiyan? Are you going to kneel before your superior and accept your fate, or do I have to beat the life out of you? And with Vegeta shown exiting a crater, he then went along to respond to Zycor, one lucky shot and you've already assumed that the battle is over? Typical. If you think I'm done, then I must have hit you harder than I thought I did. I'm not finished, not by a long shot. And now that we've skipped the warm-up, let's settle this once and for all. Show me what you can do, and that's exactly what Zycor does, because as soon as Zycor dashes on in, he then goes on to shout, ha, I thought you'd never ask, Vegeta. Before Vegeta ends up doing the exact same thing, as they go on to collide with Vegeta having to miss his punch, Trunks went on to further add, I can sense Dad's energy spike. He has to finish him off now before it's too late, with Krillin responding, Vegeta seems to be doing what he can out there, but I don't like the way Zycor is going about this right now, Trunks. What's he hiding? As of course we then go back to the fight itself, we notice how Vegeta ends up kicking Zycor in the neck as he goes on to tell him, it's only a matter of time before you can only take so much before your body starts to break down on you. As of course Zycor ends up grabbing onto Vegeta's leg, he then responds, that won't work on me again. As he then went on to flip Vegeta forward in slamming his body down onto the ground, Zycor then continues, nothing you do will save you from the beating you have coming, Vegeta. He's killing him out there, Krillin says. Should we help him? With Trunks responding, wait, if we go in there now, we just might get in Father's way. As of course Zycor is shown continuously stomping down on Vegeta's face over and over and over again, as he does so, Zycor then puts this into question by asking, where did all of that confidence you had a minute ago just go? Giving up already, Saiyan? Is this the best you could do? With Vegeta shown being dragged, he then went on to say to himself, damn him, how does he have this much power left? With, of course, Zycor approaching, he then went on to tell Vegeta, what a complete waste of time, Vegeta. I told you that this was going to be your fate. Was I wrong? No. any last words, and as soon as Vegeta ends up lifting his hand up, he then went on to tell him, the only words who are going to be their last are going to be yours. Now die! Big Bang Attack! And as soon as Vegeta fires this Big Bang Attack from the ground, this ends up connecting fully, as of course this was done from a very short distance. As the blast approaches, Zykor went on to say to himself, how does this worm still have this much power left? You think this is going to stop me, Vegeta? You think this is where it ends? And as soon as the Big Bang Attack makes contact, there is a massive explosion shown to where even Broly himself, as of course he is observing this fight, shields himself from the blast and the wind gust created. It's interesting to see how both Broly and PyCon seem to be observing this, with of course PyCon also doing the same thing. As the dust begins to settle, PyCon goes on to comment, that won't be enough. With, of course, Vegeta shown standing on up and assuming that the fight was over, Vegeta then went on to comment, consider it done. That's what you get for thinking you can overtake me. But then, that's when Trunks went on to cry out, Father! He's behind you! As unbeknownst to Vegeta, what Zykor ends up doing is he teleports right behind him in double axe handling Vegeta right across the head by telling him, consider it done, right Vegeta? And this completely ends up knocking Vegeta out of Super Saiyan 4. As of course, Vegeta then reverts back down to his base form as he goes tumbling down. Zykor then went on to add, what better way than to knock the so-called Prince of all Saiyans out cold? And as soon as Vegeta ends up dropping on down to the ground, Zykor then stands over him by telling him, look at you, eating dirt, just like the last time. What did you think was going to change? You surely improved, but not to the extent needed to destroy me. Because you can't! There is no amount of power you can train for that's going to be enough to kill me. None of you have the power to stop me now. I am beyond your understanding. And since Vegeta is out, the rest of you fools are next on my list. Hey, wait, says Krillin. Trunks, is he talking about us? We have no other choice than to fight him, Krillin, says Trunks. We are all the Earth has left. And with Zykor pointing at them, he then goes on to tell them, the two of you stay right where you are. Once I'm done crushing this fool, you both are next. And don't try running away either. Your speed is child's play compared to mine. So if you bother to run, I will catch you and finish you off on the spot. Now, where were we, dear prince? Let's just see how much punishment your spine can take before it snaps in two. As Zykor then proceeds to stomp down on Vegeta's back, Trunks is not having it because from there, he ends up transforming into a Super Saiyan by charging on in and crying out, I won't let you kill my father! But Zykor quickly moves on in and uppercutting Trunks right in the stomach by telling him, and how are you planning to stop me then? With this, and as soon as Trunks ends up collapsing, Zykor then continues, how pathetic. You are even worse than your father is. As he then went on to grab Vegeta by the back of the hair and lifting his head up, he then continues, now where were we, sweet prince? Ah, that's right. I am going to drag you across this entire planet before ending your life. Come, let's take a ride. And with Trunks powerless to do anything, he went on to say to himself, I can't let him do this to father. He's the only one we have that can stand up to him. Without Dad, we'll have nobody to help stop this monster from destroying Earth. Damn you, I won't let you get away with this. As he tries to attack Zykor, Zykor went on to grab onto Trunks' throat by asking him, then how will you stop me? What could you possibly do that your father couldn't? Nothing, that's what. As he then went on to headbutt Trunks right in the face, he then continues, you people need to face the truth, that there is nothing any of you can do that's going to change the outcome of your fate. Now stay out of my way, you worm. As Zykor went on to kick Trunks away, he then continues, your father is the one I'm after, and once he's out of the picture, make no mistake about it, you're next. And be a good little boy and watch from the sidelines as your father dies. And as Vegeta slowly begins to open his eyes and realizing that his son is in trouble, that's when Vegeta goes on to comment, no, Trunks. As he then quickly, out of pure rage, ends up powering right back up to Super Saiyan 4, he then went on to tell Zykor, I am not finished with you, Zykor. Leave my son out of this. With Zykor responding, where is he getting this power from? You were finished. As Vegeta went on to then punch Zykor away, he then responded, I am tired of playing these games. This is where you die. once and for all. And as Zycor hits the floor, Vegeta goes on to ready himself in unleashing a massive attack by telling Zycor, this next attack will be my all. Everything I have. As Zycor goes on to stand up, visibly angry, he then asks, is that so? Do your worst, with Vegeta responding, oh, I will. This next attack will rip you to pieces. Good luck surviving this one. What's this spike of power, Zycor asks. Now disappear, Vegeta cries. Gamma Burst Flash! And as soon as Vegeta winds up firing this attack at Zycor, Zycor, instead of having to move away, ends up guarding himself and responding, your final attack then? I will prove to you that even your most powerful attack still won't be enough to take me down. And with Vegeta's gigantic attack having to then consume Zycor whole, PyCon then went on to comment, oh, what a massive attack! Who knew Vegeta would have had this much power still remaining? And with Vegeta standing with his arms out, he then went on to comment, that should be enough. There is no way he could have survived that, not without at least taking massive amounts of damage. I can't feel his ki. Is it over? Wait. No. I can still feel something there. And through the smoke, we get to then observe how Zycor is in fact still shown standing there, as Zycor went on to comment, Vegeta, you dirty disgrace of a warrior. That attack of yours actually hurt. But I'm not dead yet. Not yet, Vegeta. There's just no way, Vegeta says. How? How were you able to survive that attack? With Zycor responding, how? Because I am the ultimate life form. You can thank Goku for his genetics in giving me the perfect body to work with. I'm sure you wouldn't happen to know where he might be, but I'll find him one way or another once I'm done here. As Vegeta goes on to ask, how am I supposed to kill this bastard if his body can't seem to break? With Zycor then telling Vegeta, my turn now. And as soon as Zycor dashes on in, he then went on to tell Vegeta, you should have finished me off when you had the chance. I can promise that you won't have another one. And with Zycor punching Vegeta in the face, he then continues, remember, I can adapt just like you. As part Saiyan, I can learn from these moments of danger and adjust accordingly to my opponent. I know all about your rage boost, Vegeta, and it won't work on me this time. And with Vegeta literally being shown beaten, he went on to then say to himself, there's no use. He keeps coming back as though he is some kind of a machine. I'm not sure how long I can go. It's like he's getting stronger by the minute. His attacks are much heavier than they were a little while ago, because although Zycor had delivered a bone-rattling shot to Vegeta's stomach, he then further went along to get behind Vegeta and grabbing onto his tail by then asking, you think I wouldn't know about this? The source of a Saiyan's power, is that right? Let's swing it on over on this side then. As Zycor went along to swing Vegeta forward, he went on to slam Vegeta on his back, with of course Vegeta shown in pain, he went on to then say to himself, damn, it's no use. I needed more time to train. He's too much. It's as though he's not even taking this fight seriously. And with Zycor shown lifting up his leg, he then responded to Vegeta by telling him, this fight is over, chimp. You have nothing on a god. As he further went on to then stomp down directly on Vegeta's face, Zycor then comments, yeah, that feels about right. Just what I love to see. This is how I remembered it to be from before. How about you? Do you remember? As Zycor just keeps on stomping down on Vegeta's face, he then continues, I think I'm going to continue to kick your face in until your brains are all over the floor. I'll welcome my father to a wonderful red carpet after I drag him from the afterlife. Keep resisting all you want, says Zycor. It's only a matter of time before you stop breathing, Vegeta. As he then continues to stomp down over and over and over again, Krillin is left observing as he then went on to say to himself, ah, forget it. I can't just sit around and watch him do this to Vegeta. I have to try and do something. Hey! Leave him alone, says Krillin. As he tries jumping on in, what Zycor ends up doing is he so casually backhands Krillin away by telling him, wait your turn, weakling. And with Krillin shown having to land right next to Trunks, Zycor is in full control over this battle because he incapacitated Trunks, he knocked Krillin away, and now the strongest fighter arguably on the battlefield is getting his brain stomped out. And as he does so, Zycor just keeps on kicking Vegeta's head in over and over until Vegeta powers right back down to base form yet again, and as he does with Zycor shown stomping on down, Zycor then went on to comment, and just like that, this fight is done. I feel guilty for not getting rid of you sooner. I guess you talked yourself up into getting me interested in this new power of yours you kept bragging about. And now look, you are finished. There's nothing left you can do to stand in my way. I am going to end you the way you should have been ended when I first landed on this cursed rock. Death was already at your doorstep. Kame! And as soon as Zycor is then shown charging up for a massive Kamehameha, he only then continues to pour in more of his energy into this attack as he continues to charge it, but then, unbeknownst to everyone, out of nowhere, Broly ends up saving the day by showing up just in the nick of time by kicking Zycor into the distance and having to free himself from Vegeta, and as Zycor lands on his feet, he then goes on to ask, "What was that just now? It couldn't have been Vegeta." But of course. So Zycor now knows, as only then we get to see, how Super Saiyan Broly is standing in defense for Vegeta, as of course he's on the ground, he's unconscious, and with Broly slowly turning back and having to acknowledge Vegeta being on the ground, he further went on to address Vegeta by telling him, "You are my prey to destroy, Vegeta, and I will not let someone take that away from me. I was promised to fight Kakarot once this Saiyan is dead, and that's exactly what I intend to happen." And with Zycor having to look on, he then went on to comment, "Ah yes, the Saiyan my mother told me about. The one of legend, Broly, is it? Now I see. So, they must have brought him back to life somehow. What's he planning?" And with Broly shown reaching on down, he then went on to grab Vegeta by the neck by telling him, "I could snap your neck and kill you right now, Vegeta. You are pathetic." So in the meantime, as he then went on to lift him up, he then tells him, "I want you to remember that once he's dead, you'll be the next to follow. I still haven't forgotten what you did to me." And with Krillin and Trunks sitting on up, that's when Krillin went on to tell Trunks, "Oh no, Trunks! Broly looks like he's going to kill Vegeta! This is not good! Whose side is he even on?" With Trunks responding, "Wait, no! Look, Krillin," with Broly responding, "you will watch from the sidelines. If you get in my way in this fight, I'll kill you before I kill him. Now get out of my face." As he then went on to toss Vegeta directly in Trunks and Krillin's direction, he then went on to tell them, "Do what you will with him, but keep him around. Once this fight is over, he will be my next target, along with the rest of you. I am not doing this for any of you. I am doing this only because I want my fight with Kakarot." And as soon as Broly then goes on to address Zycor, he then went on to ask, "A hybrid, huh? You are nothing. I will show you true power." As only then, Majub ends up making a surprise entrance by having to tell everyone, "Heads up, everyone! I finally made it. I got something for us. I grabbed these from Korin. Give Vegeta a Senzu Bean fast while he's still breathing." And with Zycor visibly angry, he then went on to address Broly by telling him, "You think your outdated power is going to make a difference in this battle? I'll have no problem sending you back into the afterlife. Goku is mine to destroy, not you." With Broly responding, "Kakarot was destined to die by my hands and my hands only, and I won't let some carbon copy get in the way of killing him. Nothing will stop me from getting my revenge on him." And as soon as Broly charges on in, he then went on to tackle Zycor by having to use his body as a battering ram, but then, as soon as Zycor ends up countering by uppercutting Broly in the face, he then went on to tell him, "You honestly think you have enough power to stop me? And what exactly are you hoping the outcome will be?" But Broly's not having it, because from there, he went on to grab Zycor by the face and pushing him further back out by crying out, "Die!" With everyone else shown having to eat their Senzu beans, Krillin then went on to comment, "I don't think we can thank you enough, Majub. For a minute, I thought we were going to die out there," with Vegeta chiming in, "Broly will die out there if this goes on. He's acting on instinct, but he doesn't have the power to finish it. I felt something much deeper within Zycor as he attacked me. this is not going to be as easy as we thought. And from my understanding, it looks as though this is only his base form. Damn it! Broly's fighting a losing battle here. This freak isn't like anyone we've faced before. It's like he knows what we're about to do before we do it. With Trunks asking, but if you and Broly can't do it, then what can we do, Dad? As Majub also chimes in, well, we can't just sit here then and let him kill Broly. He may not fully be on our side, but we still need him. The hell with this. I'm not just going to sit here and let that bastard tear us apart one by one. We have to try something, even if it means nothing. We have to try. And right before Majub can go on ahead and make his move, Vegeta went along to stop Majub by telling him, don't be foolish. He'd kill you within seconds. You'd only make matters worse. Stand down and wait. None of you have the ability to make a change in this fight, which is why you'd need to be our support unit instead. If you go in, you'll die. I want to see if Broly can expose anything that we can take advantage of. I'll rejoin the fight at the right moment, but in the meantime, you will all stay where you are, with Krillin responding, are you sure? What if he can't do it alone? There's no telling what Zycor is hiding or planning, but we trust you, as over out into the distance, we get to see how Broly is literally dragging Zycor through the landscape as Trunks went on to ask, are you guys seeing this? This doesn't look good. They'll destroy the Earth if this continues. But I think Broly is pushing him back, as indeed he is, and with Broly shown pushing Zycor back, he then went on to cry out, Kakarot is mine! Die! And as soon as Zycor is able to counter, he then went on to tell Broly, you are really starting to annoy me, Saiyan. As Broly attempts to attack Zycor each and every single time he finds an opportunity to, that's when Zycor went on to mock Broly by telling him, look at you. You can't even touch me. You call yourself a Saiyan? I don't see what's so legendary about you. Another waste of time. So this was something that Broly had in mind in finishing off Zycor to complete the promise made in having Goku be the one to come back in fighting Broly, and as Broly kept on attacking Zycor, that's when Zycor went along ahead to grab onto Broly's punch by telling him, if this is the best you can do, then you're just wasting my time, Saiyan. And with Broly taken back, Zycor then went on to tell him, now, it's my turn. Father, do you feel that, Trunks says? Broly's power, his energy is beginning to drop at a rapid pace, says Vegeta. Zycor is in control, and Zycor is, because from there, Broly's body comes flying out through the other side of the mountain as he then went on to land right in front of everyone. That's when Krillin even went on to comment, hey look, I never thought I'd ever see the day where Broly would get manhandled like this. This is not good, guys, because nobody ever expected for Broly to get put in his place this quickly by Zycor, and with, of course, Vegeta having to observe, he then comments, damn it, even Broly? It's as though he was swatted like a fly. Hey, can you still fight? Get up! And that's exactly what Broly does, because even though Broly is showing signs of pain, he then went on to tell Vegeta he's mine. He won't kill me that easily. Kakarot is mine! And with Vegeta shown joining Broly, he then went on to tell him, well, in order to get to Kakarot, we have to kill him first. Hold nothing back. Once he is dead, you'll get your fight with both me and Kakarot like we've agreed. With Broly responding, I didn't ask for your help, Vegeta. But if you insist, then just stay out of my way. I wasn't brought back to be surpassed by weaklings or hybrid offsprings. Just use everything you've got on him, says Vegeta, and don't hold anything back, with of course Zycor shown rapidly approaching both of them as of course he's ready for war. That's when Vegeta went on to power back into Super Saiyan 4 and telling Broly, now come on, Saiyan! And Broly is pissed because Broly isn't one to be taken advantage of or having to be put down in a fight so easily, so Broly begins to power up into his full-powered Super Saiyan form, and with Broly wielding his legendary transformation, that's when Vegeta side-by-side went along to tell him, use everything you have against him. Here he comes! And with Zycor approaching, he then went on to address the two of them by telling them, you think that by adding another Saiyan onto your roster that it will increase your chances of beating me? I'll crush you both! As meanwhile, in the Dragon Realm, we get to observe how Goku is in fact sparring against Omega Shenron, mind you, in his base form, with Purunga having to observe by adding, the Saiyan continues to grow stronger by the hour. He's no longer counting on using a transformation to hold his own against Omega Shenron. The more he continues to expand his power by adapting to his opponent, the greater of a fighter he will become. which puts into question the true power the Saiyan is hiding from Omega. If what I'm sensing is correct, then the Saiyan may have found a power beyond his previous Super Saiyan 4 level. His potential is worth studying, for he is unlike any other Saiyan. So of course, in the Dragon Realm, Goku is taking it upon himself to battle against Omega by not having to use any other transformation outside of having to rely on his base form, which Purunga himself even went as far as to confirm that since this training had begun, Goku just keeps on growing in power, but also insinuates the idea that perhaps maybe Goku had tapped into a power and had discovered something far beyond Super Saiyan 4. As Goku was shown further engaging against Omega, he then went along to tell him, "So when are you going to stop holding back and show me what you can really do, Omega? You've been dragging this on for quite some time now," with Omega responding, "As soon as you reveal to me your power first. You think I haven't noticed? You've been holding back too." And with Goku shown breaking right through Omega's defenses and punching him in the face, that's when Goku went on to tell him, "Then far be it from me to make you wait then. If you don't show me what you can do, then this fight is over." As they then go on to a test of strength, that's when Omega went along to reply to Goku by telling him, "Don't get ahead of yourself, monkey. I'm only as strong as I allow you to see." And with Purunga and the other Shadow Dragons observing, Purunga then went along to add, "Watch. You can feel the tension between them. One of them is about to break. And if I'm not mistaken, Goku is going to be the first to make his move. Watch. He's about to evolve." And as soon as Omega and Goku break away, that's when Goku went on to tell Omega, "All right then, Omega, let's settle this battle for good. Now I'm about to show you the ultimate power of the Saiyan race. I haven't had much time to polish this one, but consider this the apex power of my people. If you thought Super Saiyan 4 was impressive, then wait until you see the next level beyond it." As we then go back to Earth, we get to see how full-powered Legendary Super Saiyan Broly and Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta are relentlessly trying to attack Zycor, with of course Zycor defending himself. He then went on to tell them, "You idiots just don't get it, do you? This power and body comes from the greatest Saiyan to ever live. What makes you think you can stop me?" With Zycor then uppercutting Vegeta, he then went on to continue, "No matter how many times you try, or how many of these idiots you recruit, it won't be enough to kill me." With Broly quickly attempting to attack Zycor from the side, Zycor went on to block the attack by telling Broly, "You had your chance of killing Goku and you failed. Your power was a prelude to what came after. You failed." I wonder how Goku would feel if he saw you here on Earth again. It's too bad you will never see his face or mine ever again. As Zycor proceeded to kick Broly in the ribs, he then continues, "Because it's only going to be a matter of time before you die. We won't let you," says Vegeta as he went along to punch Zycor. Zycor went on to break his fall by balancing his momentum by responding, "You are more annoying than I thought you'd be, Vegeta. But this has run its course. The two of you are holding on by a thread. But I just love inflicting as much pain on those who have it coming. Now then, let's wrap this up once and for all." And with Broly and Vegeta standing side by side, Zycor then went on to continue, "I hope the two of you know that no matter what it is that you do, you can't beat me. An outdated so-called legend and one lousy Super Saiyan 4 won't get you very far. I'm not interested in playing these games with you, but since Goku isn't here, I might as well get what I can out of this before ending your lives. Once I break the two of you, I will go on to blow this planet into pieces and go on the search in finding my father. And when I do, I will break him too. But not before discovering the true nature of a Saiyan's full power. This is all just the beginning of my evolution, and the two of you are just getting in my way. You fools are only continuing to make me stronger, so go on, what's your next move?" And with Broly and Vegeta visibly angry, Vegeta went along to respond, "Sir, enough of this! Let's go, Broly! I'm sick of playing his games!" And as soon as Broly attempts to charge on in, Zycor went on to respond, "You still don't get it, do you?" And just before Broly went on to clothesline Zycor, what Zycor did was he went on to stop Broly with one hand by responding, "Honestly now, did you really think that was going to work on me again? No chance! You have no chance, beast! As Zycor proceeded to then punch Broly directly in the gut, not only was Zycor cognitive enough in stopping Broly from clotheslining him, but as soon as Broly went flying right back to Vegeta, Vegeta's had enough, and as he ends up charging right back at Zycor, he went on to shout, "Damn it all! Just who do you think you are thinking the outcome of this is going to sway in your favor?" As he went along to punch Zycor, he then continues, "As long as I'm breathing, you won't see the light of victory on my watch," with Zycor responding, "Don't worry, Vegeta, that won't be long from now." As he proceeded to knee Vegeta in the face, he then continues, "I can feel your power slowly slipping away, Vegeta." And as Vegeta hit the ground, he then went on to say to himself, "Damn him, how is he able to keep this up like this?" But Zycor's not having it, because from there, he went on to stomp down on Vegeta's face by having to then comment, "And now that he's put in his place, come at me, brute. Let's see if you can get me off him." And that's exactly what Broly does, because Broly from there attempted to attack Zycor while, of course, the challenge was presented, in seeing if Broly was able to move Zycor from Vegeta's face. But even with Broly attacking Zycor, that's when Zycor went along to tell Broly, "Come on, is that all you can do? I said come and give me a challenge, not shower me in tickles, you powerless Saiyan." As he then manages to knock Broly back, that's when Majub went on to leap over Broly and charging directly at Zycor by shouting, "We're not going to let you destroy our planet. One way or another, we will stop you." And with Majub attempting to strike Zycor, it was at that moment where Zycor went on to grab onto Majub's punch by telling him, "And just what exactly do you think you can do to stop me? You've got to be joking. You're not even worth looking at. Get away from me, you insect." As he then went on to punch him, "This isn't about you or your friends," because right now Zycor is eyeing Vegeta and Broly in this fight, so he wants to make sure that Majub knows this and the fact that Zycor will come after him after he's done with Broly and Vegeta. And with Vegeta grabbing onto Zycor's foot and lifting it from his face, that's when Vegeta went on to tell him, "Get your foot off me! So, you're still able to fight, huh?" As Zycor was taken back, that's when Vegeta went on to leap on up and uppercutting Zycor by telling him, "Even if you're stronger than me, I'm still going to find a way to beat you, even if it kills me. I won't lose to a lab rat like you." And with Broly getting behind Zycor, that's when Vegeta shouted, "Grab him now, Broly!" "What?" Zycor says, because it was at that moment where Broly managed to get behind Zycor and wrapping his arms around him, with Zycor asking, "Where did you, damn you Saiyan, let go of me right now? I said let go of me right now!" And with Vegeta closing on in, he then went on to inform Broly by telling him, "Whatever you do, do not let him go. I'm going to smash your skull in and I'm going to enjoy every second of it, you wannabe carbon copy. Now you lose," with Zycor responding, "No, Vegeta, no. This is where you lose. I will not fall to you." As he then went on to kick Vegeta away, it is very clear at this point that whatever it is that Broly and Vegeta do is proven to be ineffective against Zycor, as Zycor went on to respond, "You think binding me is going to help you? You think holding me in place is going to ensure your survival? I will not be humiliated by any of you again." And as he begins to power up, Broly is losing control because Zycor is beginning to muscle his way out of this, and with Majub having to stand back up, Majub went on to comment, "We're not getting anywhere fighting him like this. He's making this look like a cakewalk. How are we supposed to win like this? I've got to keep trying. There has to be a way to beat him. He has to have some kind of weakness to him, because even with everyone trying to do everything collectively, it's really still not getting anyone anywhere, because Zycor's proven to be superior by comparison to everyone that's trying." And with Zycor powering up and having to blow Broly away, that's when he went on to punch Broly by telling him, "You were never my equal." As Broly is sent flying, that's when Vegeta went on to stand back up and acknowledging Zycor by stating, "Damn him, we can't seem to find a weakness. He just keeps on coming. Not even Broly is strong enough to do anything to stop him. We're getting nowhere. If it comes down to it, I have no other choice. I'll do what I did with Majin Buu and take him down with me. It's that or we die." And with Zycor looking down on Vegeta, he then went on to ask him, "Does it hurt knowing that you can't stop me? I can only imagine how damaged your pride is knowing that your Super Saiyan 4 power is child's play to me." Are you ready to die now? With Vegeta responding, just where do you get off saying this power's child's play? I'm far from done with you. There's still a few things I've yet to try. So don't go celebrating just yet because you won't get off that easy. I know you have a weakness and I'll do everything in my power to find it and use it against you. You're not unbeatable. You're just like everyone else who thought the same thing. And just like them, you will fall. And as we then go back to Gohan and Dende, Gohan had finally managed to find the last Dragon Ball in retrieving it for Dende by telling him, Dende, I got it! I found the last Dragon Ball! We don't have much time. I'm sensing both Vegeta and Broly's power is going down sharply, with Dende responding, quickly then Gohan, give it here! We must do this as fast as possible. Do you think this will work, says Gohan? Is there any way we can bring back Dad like this? We don't have many options left outside of this, with Dende responding, it won't be easy to do, but there is a possibility that we can. It's very rare to pull off, but if the ritual is successful, then Goku will come back. But it will require everyone's help in order for this to work the way it should. This hasn't been done for thousands of years, but it's worth a shot. This will take a little time to get the Dragon Balls to reactivate, but I need you to bring everyone up here for us to see this through, with Gohan having to look on over by responding, we haven't faced anyone like this guy before. And for us to need Dad's help like this, it really does go to show how desperate we are to stop him. But I'm not even sure if Dad could beat him at this point, but it's worth a shot. He's the only one that can do it. I'm not sure how I'm going to bring everyone up here without Zykor following us, but I'll do my best to draw his attention away from here. Dende, are you sure this will work? With Dende responding, it's the only shot we have, Gohan. And with Gohan nearing the edge of the lookout, he then went on to comment, all right, well, I guess it's now or never. I'm not sure how I'm going to do this, but I'll give it my all. I have to think of a way to keep Zykor down there long enough for Dad to come back, but it'll take a miracle to pull this off. Maybe we can blindside him or attack him at once with something big in order to hold him off. If this fails, then it's all over. I'm not sure where Dad is, but wherever you are, we need you now more than ever. Well, here we go. I'm off, Dende. Do what you have to do and I'll be back with everyone shortly, with Dende responding, be careful, Gohan. And that's when Gohan went along ahead to fly back down on the Earth as he went along to say to himself, I only have one shot to pull this off. Let's hope he doesn't catch on. We need you, Dad. You're our last hope. As meanwhile, within the Dragon Realm, we get to see how base Goku is training with Omega Shenron, with the two having to then break away. There seems to be lots of tension building up between both of them, as Omega Shenron went on to tell Goku, remarkable. You never cease to amaze me, Goku. I never thought there would be another form beyond your Super Saiyan 4. But I guess training here would do that for you, right? You can't maintain that power, can you? With Goku responding, I never imagined for there to be anything beyond Super Saiyan 4, but I continue to push myself in order to find out. I was shocked when I discovered it, but I'm happy that I did. I told you that you wouldn't stand a chance, especially not against what I am now. This power is my ultimate level, and once I master it, I would master the Saiyan's power in its entirety. So although it's a little unstable now, it was still more than enough to beat you, and I don't even have to break a sweat in doing it, with Omega responding, for now, Saiyan. You aren't the only one who could become stronger in time. Consider this a fluke win, but it won't happen again. As Goku went on to respond, training in this realm allowed me to unlock powers that I never even knew were possible. I have to continue to work with it if I ever hope to master that kind of power, with Omega responding, you do that, and I'll continue to study you and your weaknesses until we clash again. And when we do, you won't be so cocky against me again. And that's when Purunga the Dragon went on to address Goku by then telling him, that's enough. Come down to me, Goku. You are to be acknowledged. And with both Omega and Goku having to descend on down, Goku went on to further acknowledge Omega by telling him, we'll pick this back up another time, Omega. If you could truly get stronger, then I'm looking forward to it, especially if you can push my new power even further. With Omega responding, I'll do more than just push you, Goku. I'm going to slaughter you. We'll see about that, says Goku. I doubt it, as Purunga chimes in, you are indeed unlike anything we've ever seen, Goku. Our power stood as the apex until you came along. And even then, we doubted you would ever surpass us, but you ultimately did. But the question is, can you maintain this power without destroying your own body? You've achieved a level that shakes the core of this realm, and that isn't an easy feat for one to do. Do you not know how powerful you've become? With Goku asking, why does it matter? I know I'm a lot stronger now, but what are you trying to get at? With Purunga responding, this new power of yours could easily crush anything your Super Saiyan 4 transformation couldn't, including besting it while using a small portion compared to how you would while using your full power as a Super Saiyan 4. Dare I say, this new power of yours is even stronger than the fusion you used to fight against Omega Shenron on Earth. In fact, I would say far above it. This new level of yours places you above fusion, which would only make you the strongest living mortal in the universe by far. But without proper control, this power will tear your body apart, including your spirit, which would be torn in half trying to control it. Be careful with what you possess, Saiyan, as Omega overhears this and responding, stronger than the fusion he faced me with? Surely that cannot be, especially for one mortal to be that powerful. Remarkable. How did he do it? With Goku asking, I get that, which is why I'm training to properly control it, so why did you call me down here? With Purunga having to point out by responding, there is something I'd like to show you. Over there, the Dragon Gateway. It only ever glows when we are needed, but it doesn't call for us. The gateway calls for you, Goku. It would appear as though someone is trying to summon you, with Goku responding, someone's trying to summon me? But why? I was told I could never leave. And as we only then make our way back to Earth and seeing how Zycor is manhandling Broly, he then went on to tell him, away with you, fool! Before punching Broly directly down onto the ground, Vegeta attempted to snake attack Zycor from behind in his attempts of kicking him, and as he did, Zycor went on to sense Vegeta by telling him, I hope you know, Vegeta, this was your last attempt of stopping me, because from here on out, I am ending our battle. For good this time, as he went on to duck underneath by having to uppercut Vegeta in the face, with a base form Broly who was also on the ground shown beaten and damaged, he also went on to comment, I can't, he's too strong, which is also very evident in seeing Vegeta revert back down to his base form, and as he does, Zycor went on to stand over Vegeta by telling him, that was your last chance, Vegeta, you won't be getting any more after this. And just what exactly did you prove? You proved absolutely nothing, that's what. You never had a chance against me. You certainly did better than how you did before, but it was all for nothing. This is where you die. But then, Trunks ends up transforming into Super Saiyan 3 and seeing his father be helpless, and that's when he went on to charge on him by shouting, I won't let you kill him! But in his failed attempts of stopping him, Zycor went on to blast Trunks back by telling him, you'll have your turn, boy. Now stay out of my way. And with Trunks being knocked right in front of Majub's feet, Majub went along to shout, Trunks! Get up! Don't quit now! We have to keep trying! Get up! And as soon as Zycor then redirects his focus back down on Vegeta, he then continues, honestly now, I don't know how you managed to survive all these years as Goku's rival in power. All you did was warm me up. You talked a mighty big game, only to lie in the ground where you belong. Neither you or your friends were enough to stop me. And as he then went on to stick his arm out, Zycor then continues, I'm going to take great pleasure in doing this. It's what I should have done a long time ago. I want you to always remember this. Once I'm done here, it'll be your son who's next. Then this planet. Then the galaxy. All until I find and destroy my father. Good night, Prince of all Saiyans. Make peace with death and be gone forever. Until then, out of nowhere, a voice goes on to shout, I won't let you, Zycor! That voice says Zycor. Until then, out of nowhere, Super Saiyan 4 Gohan comes in for the save. In rocking Zycor in the face with Zycor having to look on in absolute anger, he then went on to shout, Gohan! Because the last person that Zycor had ever expected to come through was in fact Gohan, and with Gohan knocking Zycor away, Gohan then went along to acknowledge him by stating, I haven't forgotten about what you've done. This is far from over, but don't worry, we have something planned for you. And with Gohan shown charging something up in his hand, he then continues, hopefully this works. It's the best thing we've got right now. Hopefully this blinds him. And with Gohan shooting this attack up in the sky, he then goes on to acknowledge this by commenting, alright, this should do. If he goes anywhere near it, it'll explode and blind him for a moment, which should give us enough time to figure something out. And with Gohan quickly grabbing Vegeta and making the save, he then continues, "I got you, Vegeta. We need you for this. Without you, there's no way we can bring back my dad." And as Gohan quickly rushes towards Trunks and Majub, he went along to then tell them, "Quickly, everyone, listen up. Grab Broly and meet me as fast as you can on the lookout. We don't have too much time. We're going to try and bring back my dad. But in order for us to do it, we all need to be on the lookout." So this was Gohan's ultimate plan in trying to come up with somewhat of a diversion in knocking Zaikor away. And with Trunks asking the lookout, "But why? How would we be able to bring Goku back?" with Gohan responding, "We'll need to power the Dragon Balls using our energy. It's a ritual that we all need to be a part of for it to work. We don't have too much time. We can't let Zaikor follow us up there either." But then, PyCon winds up showing up and having to acknowledge their plan by responding, "You all go. Grab Broly and head back to the lookout. I'll stay here and buy us as much time as I can. I'll do what I can, but there's no telling how long I can spare. So get a move on. If I fail, I will activate your flare ball and blind him before he can reach you. Now get going," with Gohan responding, "Thank you. Be careful, PyCon." And with both Trunks and Majub picking up Broly, Majub went on to tell Trunks, "Alright, we got him. Now let's get the heck out of here while we still can, Trunks." And with Majub, Trunks, and Gohan having to leave, Gohan then went along to respond, "This is our only chance. We can't blow it now. Let's hope PyCon can do what he can to keep that beast at bay. We need you, Dad." With everyone then shown having to leave with the exception of PyCon, Majub went on to put this into question as Majub went on to ask Gohan, "Are you sure about leaving PyCon alone down there with that psycho? What if we can't bring Goku back? Then our efforts will all be for nothing," as Trunks went on to chime in, "And even if we do somehow manage to bring Goku back from the afterlife, then what about Broly? It's too dangerous to keep him around," with Gohan responding, "PyCon knows what's on the line, so he isn't doing this for nothing. It's the only chance we have. We have to trust him. I have no doubt that he'll do his best. And as for Broly, he knows better than to get out of line. We promised him a fight with my dad if the situation here is taken care of. So if that's what he's after, then the only way to get what he wants is to help us finish this." And with PyCon shown having to observe the massive ball of light in the sky, PyCon went on to comment, "That ball of light. I see what Gohan did. It'll come in handy just in case. I'm not sure how long I can keep him down here with me, but I'm not looking to go down without putting up a fight." To where it was at that moment where Zaikor became completely enraged by powering up, and as he did, he went on to blow everything around him away as Zaikor went on to shout, "Who do you think you are? Gohan! You can't hide from me! You escaped me once, but you and your friends will not live to see another day and escape me again! I am Zaikor, the ultimate embodiment of power, the strongest life form in the universe. I will not stand to allow you and your pathetic friends to live. I will destroy everything. I will go on to destroy everything, everything you've ever known and loved. You will all be turned into examples to those who dare oppose me, especially Goku. Now come out and face me, Gohan!" And with PyCon having to see this and being a tad bit nervous, PyCon went on to comment, "That surge just now. There's something more about him than meets the eye, but his rage could serve as my greatest weapon to use against him. I have to try. He doesn't seem to notice that I'm here. He's too focused on finding the others. This is the opening I need." And with Zaikor not noticing that indeed PyCon is in fact there, with Zaikor more focused on Gohan, Zaikor then went on to add, "They're leaving. And just where do they all think they're going? Those worms think they can escape me that easily? Wait, they've all gone off in that direction together, which means they aren't running, so they must be up to something. But what?" "Whatever it is, it won't work," Zaikor says. "I will see to it that when I find Goku, I welcome him to a boneyard filled with the bodies of his friends and family. I will not let my mother's death be in vain. You worms think you're faster than me? I'll show you true speed." As it was here that Zaikor took it upon himself in having to dash directly in their direction, and as he did, he then went on to shout, "I'll begin with you, Gohan, since I should have killed you when I had the chance, just like I did with your little brother, Goten." But right before Zaikor can go on ahead and make his next move in reaching our heroes, all of a sudden, Zaikor stops, as PyCon went on to comment, "I think you have bigger problems to worry about right now outside of them." And with Zaikor having to then look on down and noticing how PyCon had grabbed one of his legs, Zycor then went on to add, "It's you! Where did you come from? How dare you touch me? And what exactly do you hope to accomplish?" As PyCon went on to respond, "What I hope to accomplish doesn't matter. What matters is the beating you have coming for disrespecting life with your existence. If you think I'm going to allow you to go up there and follow them without taking a proper beating by me, then you have another thing coming. What a shame Goku isn't around to see this. What a walking contradiction you are. How could you dare call yourself the son of Goku when you could never be half the warrior Goku is? Forget Vegeta and Gohan. Your fight is with me now. If you're as strong as you claim, then I want to see it." And that's when PyCon went on to fling Zycor down onto the ground, but before Zycor can even hit the ground to begin with, he went on to maintain himself as PyCon was shown descending on down and getting ready to punch Zycor by telling him, "I fought against and alongside Goku in the past. You could never be his equal, no matter how hard you try and be." And it was at that moment where PyCon went on to make contact by punching Zycor in the face, but to no avail, because Zycor then went on to respond, "And what? You're supposed to be a warrior equal to Goku, is that it? What was that supposed to be?" As PyCon responds, "No way." He didn't even move a muscle, as Zycor went on to connect a thunderous uppercut by then telling PyCon, "Get out of my face! You're not worthy of dying before they are. I'm going to make you watch as I slaughter them once I bring them back here. And when it's all said and done, you will be last." And as soon as Zycor then went on to kick PyCon into the distance, PyCon went on to crash into a nearby mountain as Zycor went on to continue, "Perhaps maybe you know something that I don't about Goku, which is why you will sit there and wait. I have much to get out of you," Zycor says. As he once again took flight, Zycor then continues, "Now back to these worms. I didn't forget about you and your friends, Gohan." But then, as soon as Zycor shown trying to make his way to Gohan and the others, PyCon was in hot pursuit right behind Zycor and telling them, "I'm not going to let you reach them, you freak! You're a waste of my time," Zycor says. As PyCon then took initiative by having to respond with a gigantic attack by telling Zycor, "We'll see about that. Thunder Flash Attack!" And as soon as PyCon went on to fire this, Zycor then went on to move out of the way, as he was ultimately anticipating this, with Zycor having to then respond, "You truly don't know when to give up, do you? Why are you so hell-bent on holding me at bay from reaching them? You are really beginning to annoy me, you pest." And with PyCon shown trying to catch his breath, he then went on to respond, "So you're tough, so what? Me and Goku have seen and fought tough guys before, so I want to see what makes you different. Try me, stop hiding your true power, unless you truly aren't as strong as you claim and you're just a spineless coward with daddy issues." "Come on then," PyCon says, "if you think I'm wrong, then prove it to me. Come on, you giant baby, try and do something about it." And that's exactly what Zycor ends up doing, because Zycor winds up chasing PyCon around. As we only then wind up on Kame's lookout, we then see how everyone was able to arrive safely, as Dende went on to comment, "Gohan, you're okay! We don't have long, so we have to make this quick," as Gohan went on to respond, "I know, Dende. I truly hope this works, because PyCon is doing his best to keep Zycor from following us up here. We also brought Broly here too. We'll discuss that later, but listen, we have to heal him quick. There's no telling if Zycor will find us." And with Dende being shown doing exactly that by having to heal Vegeta first, he then went on to comment, "Stay with us, Vegeta. You'll be okay. We need you. This fight is not over and cannot end without you. He's hurt, Gohan," as Gohan responds, "He did his best out there, Dende. If it were not for him, we wouldn't have lasted out there." And with Gohan then shown approaching the Dragon Balls in which were turned to stone, he then proceeded to stick his arm out by asking, "So is this all we have to do, Dende? Just give our power into igniting the Dragon Balls? How long will this take for it to actually work?" As Dende went on to respond, "It'll require all seven of us to channel our energy directly for the gates to open within the realm that Goku is in." And with Krillin, Trunks, and Majube then shown gathering around Gohan, Gohan then went on to continue, "Alright everyone, you heard him. Give it all you have. This is the only shot we have at beating that monster. I hope Dad is ready for this. Zycor isn't anything like we've seen before. We can't slip up now," as Dende went on to shout, "Hey, he's awake! Broly's awake, Gohan!" As Broly then went on to open his eyes by asking, Where am I?" As we then see how Vegeta also went on to make his way within the group and sticking his arm out, Krillin then went on to ask, "So what do you think, Vegeta? Do you think Goku stands a chance?" With Vegeta responding, "Unless he's trained, no. I hate doing this, but it's the only option we have right now against him." And as Broly is then shown finally standing up, he then went on to ask, "What is this? Where am I? Where is that Saiyan freak? What are you pests doing over there with those stones? Where's Kakarot? With Gohan then shown turning his head and acknowledging Broly by telling him, listen, we're running out of time, and unless you want us to hold our end of the deal, then you'll need to hold up yours as well. Give your energy into the Dragon Balls here. It'll be what helps bring my father back from the afterlife. For this to work, we need you here with us. If you fall short now, all of this would have been for nothing, including your resurrection. We need my dad, Gohan says. Kakarot, you want to use my power to bring back Kakarot? As Broly is now shown slipping into a fit of rage, Vegeta then went on to address Broly by telling him, control yourself and hurry! We don't have time! You'll have your fight once this is done. Set yourself apart from your anger and give us your energy now! We can't do this without you, Gohan says. I'm sure my dad would love to fight you again as well, Broly, so please, think about why you're here. You want revenge on him, right? Well, do this, help us stop Zycor, and you'll get it. And with Broly then shown doing exactly that, he then went on to stick his hand out by responding, I will not be denied of my battle. Kakarot will be killed by my hands. And then you, Vegeta. I will never let this go. Lending you a hand will not absolve you of the punishment you have coming. Now hurry and let's get this over with. The sooner that Saiyan is gone, the quicker I'll destroy Kakarot. I will not do this for you again, as Vegeta went on to respond, remember the deal, Saiyan. Only once the hybrid is gone will you have your chance against us. Don't lose your temper once Kakarot comes back, or you won't get another chance. As Broly went on to respond, hurry this up. In which all seven of them have gathered around the Dragon Balls, and as they did, Dende then went on to chant, all right, here goes. Elder Dragon, we call for the gods to open the doors to the realm where Goku is present. Our power is a gift to open the doors to the afterlife. Open the gates of the divine realm to restore Goku in this world. Guardians of the afterlife, we call for Goku to be brought forward. Open the gates of life through death to bring him here. As Gohan went on to ask, Dende, what's happening? As Dende went on to respond, I think it's working. The power of the Dragon Balls is coursing through the other side. I think this is it. I think the message is delivered, as only then within the Dragon Realm we get to see how Goku, Purunga, and Omega Shenron are standing in front of this massive door, and as they are, Purunga went along to address Goku by telling him, they wait for you through this door, mortal. You are to be brought forward in entering the world of the living. As even Omega went on to comment, this door is the gateway to your world. You are being called to action. A call to action, Goku says. So the others need my help after all. As seconds later, we get to see how the door then begins to open, and as it does, Purunga then went on to continue, this gate will not remain open forever. You are to leave and return to Earth where your body and soul will reconnect as one, just as it was before. This ritual can only be used once per existing creature. If you are to be killed again, this ritual will never bring you back to life ever again. The afterlife is where you will remain. Forever. They wait for you, Saiyan. Go. I doubt this will be the last time you see us again anyway. Good luck, mortal. And with Goku shown having to then step through these doors, he then went on to comment, they need me. My friends and family. They need me. They're in dire need. An enemy. An enemy that's too strong for any of them to handle on their own. If I fail, I could never go back ever again. For them to need me would mean it's a matter of life and death. I hear you. I hear your cries for help. Don't worry, everyone. I'm coming. As meanwhile back on Earth, everyone seems to be wondering as to what the heck is going on, as Super Saiyan 4 Gohan went on to ask, is anyone able to feel anything? Did it work? I don't sense Dad's energy at all. Surely it had to have worked. This was our only shot. What if it didn't work? What if we weren't able to bring my dad back to help us, Gohan says. We can't win without him. He's the best chance we have at stopping Zycor down there. And there's no telling what he's doing to PyCon either. Dende, are you sure we did everything the right way? How would we know if it worked? As Dende went on to respond, I'm sure it worked. There shouldn't be a reason for it not to have. Maybe it takes time, I'm not sure. Goku should have arrived by now, as Vegeta went on to look back by responding, "Well, time is something that we don't have, so unless you have another idea, then we're going to have to go back down there and fight him. We can't wait around for Kakarot to arrive. By then, the entire Earth would be destroyed. So unless you have another plan, then we have no choice but to go back down there right now. You said this would work, right? Well, where is he? Or did we just waste our time coming here and doing this all for nothing?" As even Trunks went on to chime in by responding, "There must have been something we missed. Surely if this was the only way to bring Goku back, then he would have been here by now. So we must have done something wrong, is that right?" As Majin responds, "I don't think so, Trunks. I think we did everything Dende said the right way. There's no chance. We can't bring him back. It doesn't seem like it could be done, you guys." And as we only then make our way back down below and noticing how PyCon is on the ground, PyCon then went on to say to himself, "Aw, man, what are they doing up there? I can't keep this up for long. He's too much. Where is Goku? My body feels like it's been smashed into pieces. Hurry up before it's too late." As Zycor went on to acknowledge PyCon by asking, "What did you think was going to happen? Was it worth your life protecting those worms? You proved nothing. What happened to putting me in my place like you said you were?" And with PyCon shown slowly lifting his arm in the air, Zycor went on to ask, "What are you doing? Hoping to reach out for someone to help you? There will be no help for you today." As Zycor went on to stomp down on PyCon's chest, he then went on to continue, "Now where did Gohan and the others run off to? Either you tell me where they went, or I'm going to break every bone in your body. Now spill it. They're close by, aren't they?" "Yes. They couldn't have left the planet, which only means they're in hiding. They flew straight up, didn't they? I'm going to scout this entire planet from above, and once I find them, it's game over and lights out for all of you." But Zycor hasn't noticed that PyCon seems to be staring at something behind him, as Zycor then went on to continue, "They couldn't have gotten far. Let's settle the score once and for all so I can find and destroy Goku." And that's when Zycor went on to take his leave by flying up, and as he did, PyCon went on to shout, "Damn it, he's on the move! I have to use Gohan's energy orb. It's the last resort. If this fails, then he'll surely find the lookout and destroy them. I have no choice. Here's one last play," PyCon says. "If this fails, then I'm sorry, everyone. Please hurry. We need you, Goku." And with PyCon then shown clenching his fist, it was at that moment where Zycor had finally noticed the energy orb in the sky, and as he did, he then went on to put this into question by asking, "What is this? Was this ball of light always up here? This certainly can't be an attack, which means... wait. Oh no!" To where it was at this moment where Gohan's energy orb was then activated by PyCon and exploding right in front of Zycor's face, and as it did, PyCon quickly went on to shield himself and having to then shout, "What tremendous energy! Gohan's energy orb surely had to have worked! I can't see a thing! Wait, that's not just an energy orb," as Zycor is taken back by this because not only did this energy orb went on to blind Zycor, but it was actually a trap, a bomb set up by Gohan before he had left, and the moment we get to then see how this energy orb then went on to explode, everyone on the lookout went on to feel this, as Krillin went on to ask, "Hey, did you guys just feel that explosion down there? What the heck is going on?" As Gohan went on to respond, "PyCon likely triggered the trap that I set in case Zycor was too much for him to handle, which can only mean that PyCon is on his last leg out there. We have to hurry," as Vegeta went on to ask, "Well, then where is he? How much energy is this going to take for it to work, damn it? Dende, please," Gohan says. "We need answers. PyCon's dying down there, and if Zycor finds us on the lookout, then we're done for. What's the holdup?" As Dende responds, "I believe we need a few more minutes," and that's when Broly went on to chime in by commenting, "I'm sick of this. I'm done waiting around with you idiots here. I'm going back down there," and going back down there we do, because as soon as the dust begins to settle and we see Zycor through the smoke, Zycor went on to comment, "How dare you? You disgusting worms! That wasn't a blinding energy attack, that was an energy bomb, and it came from you, Gohan, you, I've had enough of this," Zycor shouts. "I'm done playing these games. This is where you die, warrior. You've been a thorn on my side since you arrived. It's time to put you out of your misery." And with PyCon barely shown having to stand up, he then went on to smile in telling Zycor, "Well, would you look at that? Gohan's blast gave you a little bit of a makeover there. Did you like that? I'm sure you did. The look on your face says it all. Thought I'd let you just slip away that easily? Not a chance. I'm not letting you go any but then, Zycor went on to dash in by cutting PyCon short and kicking him in the stomach by telling him, I'm tired of listening to you speak, pest. You wanted my attention? Well, this is going to be the last time that you ever get it. The only thing you managed to do was buy your friends time before I went out and found them. These cat and mouse games end right here. As PyCon is shown plopping on down, Zycor was looking to legitimately finish things as he proceeded to stick his arm out by telling PyCon, there will be nothing left of you. You've run your course here with me. Your life ends here. But then, all of a sudden, both Gohan and Vegeta are left baffled as Gohan went on to comment, hold on a second, Vegeta. Do you feel that key? I can't believe it, Vegeta says. It's him. Trunks, you sense that? Majub asks. I can't believe it, Oob. As even Broly went on to recognize this key, as Broly comments, Kakarot. As right before Zycor went on to end PyCon's life, it would only appear as though an individual went on to kick Zycor in the face, and as they did, Zycor's body is then shown flying out into the distance, and the individual responsible for this was none other than Goku. As even PyCon himself was shocked as he went on to comment, I don't believe it. It's really you. You're really here. Sorry I'm late, PyCon, Goku says, but I knew you were in trouble the moment I felt your life energy and power fade. Don't worry, just leave this guy to me. I couldn't believe it until I actually came here, Goku says. I was able to sense this guy's power all the way from the Dragon Realm. It was faint, but I knew something was going on here. And now that I know why you guys have brought me back, I'll handle this from here on. As PyCon went on to respond, Goku, you have to be careful. From what I know, he's your half-son, created by the Supreme Kai using your DNA. It's a long story, but he possesses your power and fighting potential. Whoa, really, Goku says? Well, that explains why our power kind of feels the same. I knew something was up with this guy once I felt him fighting, but don't worry. This should be fun, as PyCon responds, fun? Goku, he's dangerous. He nearly killed all of us if it wasn't for Gohan. Hey, don't worry, PyCon, Goku says. I got this, like I said. And that's when everyone on the lookout began to scramble, beginning with Gohan, as Gohan went on to shout, guys, let's go! Hurry! My dad's back! And he's down there with PyCon! We have to go right now, let's move! He might need our help against Zycor, let's not waste a second, now come on! Thank you so much for this, Dende! We owe you one big time for this! As of course, Gohan was the first to take his leave, followed by Vegeta. Vegeta then went on to comment, well, it took him long enough to get here. That power of his, Kakarot. Just what kind of training did you go through, curse you clown? He's done it again. And with everyone then beginning to follow, Dende went on to shout, hey, be careful down there, everyone. Don't hold back and beat this guy once and for all. But the only person that didn't seem to take his leave was in fact Broly, because as Broly went on to stand by the edge of the lookout and looking down, Broly went on to comment, I can't believe it. There you are. Finally. Kakarot, you scum. What is this power you're hiding? I... No. Damn you. Kakarot, you must die. And as we then go back to Zycor, who explodes in a fit of rage, he then went on to shout, come out, Gohan! You and your friends have lived long enough. I am going to destroy this entire planet along with everyone on it. This ends now. But then, Zycor had realized that it wasn't Gohan that went on to kick him in the face, but instead, it was someone completely different, as Zycor comments, wait a second, that wasn't Gohan or Vegeta. Impossible. So it's true. There, right there, there he is. That energy I'm sensing, that's him, my father, Goku. I can't believe it. Where did he just come from? I couldn't sense his arrival from anywhere. As Goku went on to tell PyCon, listen, I need you to stay back. No matter the outcome, don't get involved, got it? I need you to heal yourself. If things get messy here, then it's better to be healed than to be wounded, understand? As PyCon responds, but Goku, you can't just fight this guy by yourself. He's too strong. Listen to me, as Goku went on to shout, hey you, why don't you leave everyone else out of this? I'll be your opponent from now on. If you're looking for a battle, then you've got what you came here for. Zycor responds, so, you're the mighty Goku. Legend has it that you are the strongest of them all. How wonderful! I've been waiting for this day since I was born. It's time you paid for all the things you never lived to atone for. Father. And with Goku trying to get as much information as he could, he then went on to ask PyCon, so I take it the others went on to fight this guy as well, didn't they? Outside of your own experience with him, how did the others fare up against them? As PyCon went on to respond, not good at all. Even as Super Saiyan 4s, Vegeta and Gohan weren't able to do much against him. Even Broly tried and he could only do so much to stop him. As Goku went on to ask, wait, hold on, did you just say Broly? Like, Broly? The legendary Super Saiyan Broly that we battled all those years ago? He's alive? But how? Even he wasn't able to beat this guy? That's insane. I can't believe it. How did you guys even bring Broly back? And more importantly, why? As Zaikon went on to respond, of course they failed. I'm your son, remember? The power that flows through me comes from you. So it's only natural for me to be the alpha among the tribe. Just like you once were, I am to rule this entire universe just as Mother said you once ruled with no rival to your power. I am the ultimate life form, born without any flaws, unlike the rest of you. I trained every day of my life to see this day through. I, Zaikor, am the heir to Son Goku, the most powerful fighter in the universe, who now falls second behind me. I can tell that you're different from the others. That body has seen many battles throughout its lifetime, hasn't it? It's what I prepared for when meeting you. My mother was right about you. A mighty body with a soft and vulnerable mind. But it was only then where Gohan and the others went on to arrive, as Gohan went on to shout, Dad, you're back! It's really you! I can't believe it! It's really you! As Krillin chimes in, what took you so long, Goku? Jeez! Always looking to make a grand entrance, as Gohan continues, you had us worried for a moment. We didn't think you'd show, but I can't believe it. It's been far too long, Dad. Thank you for hearing our cries for help. We need you. With Goku then turning around and acknowledging Gohan by telling him, wow, look at you, Gohan. Super Saiyan 4. I knew you could do it. You've gotten so strong since I saw you. I'm glad you were able to keep up with your training. As well as you, Trunks, Majub, Krillin. It's so good to see you again. As Vegeta also went on to arrive by asking, all right, Kakarot, spill it. You appear to be more relaxed than you usually are. Now cough it up. What did you discover? As Goku went on to respond, well, it's good to see you again too, Vegeta. You've gotten insanely strong yourself as well, I can tell. But yeah, I did discover a few new things while I've been away. But first, I need to know where I stand. Tell me, Vegeta, is he really that difficult to fight or what? Is he any stronger than when we battled Omega Shenron together? As Vegeta went on to respond, he's much stronger than that dragon was, so yes. Fighting him one-on-one wasn't working. Stronger, huh? Goku asks. So that means he isn't going to be worth taking a risk on, especially if he has my power flowing through his body. As Vegeta went on to respond, then surely you don't expect to fight him alone then, are you? What are you hiding? I know there's something you're not telling me, Kakarot. As of course, Zaikor is then shown getting into fighting position, Goku then went on to respond, I don't know what else to say, Vegeta. I've trained non-stop since being in the Dragon Realm. I never let a day go by where I wasn't thinking of breaking my limits and becoming even stronger than what I was before. It nearly crushed me. But I think we'll be alright. It's rare for us to battle guys like this, especially those who are as strong as us or stronger, so if you don't mind, I think I want to fight him alone. I'll need you guys if I do, but I just want to see what he can do first. But even then, Zaikor took it upon himself in not wanting to waste a single second, because as soon as Zaikor went on to dash at his father, Zaikor further went on to comment, I've waited long enough for this day, Goku. You will be dethroned from being known as the strongest warrior in the universe. And as we then observe how Zaikor is then beginning to attack Goku, Krillin then went on to chime in, has Goku lost his mind? We have to help him. There's no way Goku's going to be able to take this guy all by himself. As Gohan went on to chime in, let's just wait for now, Krillin. If anyone knows what they're doing, it's my dad. I'm sure he already knows that this guy can't be taken lightly. Let's just wait for his call. As Goku went on to say to himself, aw man, what incredible force. This guy's punches are like granite. I can see what everyone meant by his strength. I have to fight back and see what I can find. And as soon as Goku then is shown having to fight back against Zycor, Goku then went on to comment, I can see now by what you meant. You fight exactly like me. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't surprised by this, as Goku went for a kick with Zycor blocking by responding, are you taking me for a fool, Son Goku? I am nothing like you. As Zycor went on to then punch Goku in the chest, he then continues, I am far beyond you in every way. I have mastered your fighting style and equipped it with my natural power. What is this? Zycor asks. How are you this slow? And Mother said you were the strongest? Surely not with power like this. And with Goku then attempting to elbow Zycor, he then went on to block off Goku's attack by telling him, I will live to see my mother's death through by destroying both you and your silly little friends when this is all over. As Zycor is then shown punching Goku in the face, Trunks then went on to add, guys, I don't think Goku's going to be able to do this. He's getting smashed out there by this guy. Let's go. But Vegeta went on to stop Trunks by telling him, you will do no such thing and stay where you are, boy. Kakarot knows what he's doing. As Zycor went on to kick Goku in the stomach, as of course Goku was shown flying backwards, Vegeta then went on to continue, you will all remain where you are. Look closely. Kakarot is finally about to take him as serious as he should. Now watch. He's about to change. As Goku comments, oh man, you weren't bluffing. You're a lot stronger than I assumed you'd be. Your attacks are deadly accurate. I knew fighting you in my base form really wouldn't work, but at least now I can have a window into your power. Guess I have no other choice than if I want to survive. Here goes. In which it was at this moment where Goku went on to transform into a Super Saiyan, and as he did, Zycor then went on to ask, this transformation? What an insult. I know you have levels beyond this. As of course Zycor went charging at Goku, Goku then went on to say to himself, I've got to get him to show me more of his true power. I can feel him hiding it from me. And as soon as Zycor went on to punch Goku, Goku went on to grab onto Zycor's punch by telling him, this isn't going to be your standard Super Saiyan form. I've enhanced each level throughout my time while I was away. And so what? Zycor asks. It won't make a bit of difference against me. Oh, but it will, Goku says, unless you show me what you can really do and you know it. I'll show you, Goku says, as he proceeded to kick Zycor in the ribs, followed by kicking Zycor in the neck. With the others having to observe this, Maju went on to add, guys, look, Goku's winning, and he's only using his Super Saiyan form to do it. As Vegeta responds, Kakarot isn't winning. Pay attention. Zycor is studying how Kakarot is using his power. In which he is, because as soon as Goku is then shown having to throw a punch, Zycor went on to move out of the way as Vegeta continues. He's observing Kakarot's movements very carefully and is improving more and more as this fight goes on. There. Take a closer look, Vegeta says. As we then see how Zycor had rammed himself directly into Goku by tackling him, Vegeta then went on to continue, for Kakarot to win, he needs to first find any weaknesses on Zycor that he could, then to exploit these in battle by using it against him. The only problem, however, is that Zycor isn't showing any openings or signs of weaknesses as he fights. Just like us Saiyans, he continues to get stronger and stronger as each fight passes by. The sooner Kakarot can see this, the better. But it doesn't look like he's able to bypass Zycor just yet. There's a 50-50 chance that he may need our help. But until Kakarot makes this clear, we are to watch and study the battle from here. Getting involved this early won't help, as Trunks went on to then comment, but what if Goku dies out there? It doesn't look like he's going to last any longer out there, as Vegeta responds, he won't. If Kakarot knew that fighting him one-on-one would result in his loss, then he would have already called for us to fuse. With Gohan then chiming in, well, if Dad loses out there, then the only option that we do have is fusion. I'm not sure about this, you guys, as Krillin went on to ask, what do you think, Trunks? Can Goku do it? Can he win? I hope so, Krillin, Trunks says. There's been a shift in the fight, PyCon comments. Do you guys feel that? It's Goku. His power just went through the roof. As out of nowhere, Zycor's body is then shown having to fly right past everyone, and as it does, everyone was shocked, as Krillin went on to ask, holy cow, what the heck was that? Was that Zycor? As Trunks responds, yeah, it was. I didn't even see him pass us by. What just happened out there? It's Goku, PyCon says. There it is. He transformed again. He knew he had to take it up a notch, so he transformed. And with everyone looking back and observing how Zycor had went crashing through the landscape, Maju then went on to comment, whoa, that That was a huge hit that he just took. What did Goku just do to him? What an impact, with Krillin asking, "You think he'll stay down for good this time, you guys?" As out of nowhere, Super Saiyan 3 Goku is then shown dashing directly at Zaikorn. As he did, Gohan then went on to comment, "There he is! It's Dad! He jumped up by using Super Saiyan 3! I can't believe how strong his form has gotten! It's nothing like it was when I've seen it before!" With Zaikorn quickly standing up by asking, "But how is this form of yours any stronger than the others? There's no way you've improved your transformations this much!" As Goku went on to get right in Zaikorn's face, he then went on to tell him, "I told you, Zaikorn, I've been through a lot of changes since I've been away, and you're about to see them." As Goku was not bluffing, because Goku went on to uppercut Zaikorn in the stomach by telling him, "I would never use this power to harm innocent people like you. You should be honored and proud to have the power that you do and use it for good, but instead, you choose to want to take it out on others and destroy anything that gets in your way. Well, I won't let you," Goku says. With Goku shown kneeing Zaikorn in the chin before having to kick him back down onto the ground, he then continues, "You'll have to fight me using everything your body is made of if you hope to win." And Zaikorn is pissed, because as soon as he went on to maintain his balance, he then went on to shout, "I couldn't see him move! So he's stronger than the others," Zaikorn adds, as he went on to clench onto his stomach. He then continues, "As it was expected from what I've heard. So, I'm now beginning to see what my mother was talking about. You really are different than the rest of them. But I just want to go ahead and remind you that anything you can do, I can do as well. So I'll give the first round to you, but now I'm about to show you exactly what I am made of, Goku." And as the situation then becomes even more intense than how it was prior, Zaikorn then went on to continue, "Very impressive, Son Goku. You exceeded my already low expectations about you. But enhancing your already flawed Super Saiyan forms isn't going to help you beat me. You see, I've also enhanced myself as well, only I've done it in my base form, the stage which you are looking at right now. I never had the need to push myself into ever needing a transformation, but I always went on to keep such a thing in my back pocket just in case I ever needed it. I went on to smash both Gohan and Vegeta when they used Super Saiyan 4, so if you think using a lower level is going to beat me, then you're more delusional than I originally thought. So now that the cat's out of the bag, what do you say? Are you going to show me what the so-called strongest is really made of, or do I need to beat it out of you?" With Goku responding, "I figured you were already aware of being able to transform yourself. So what's it going to be then? Either you're serious about your true power, or you're simply putting on an act. Either way, one of the two is bound to be revealed, and unless you plan to act now, then I don't see you lasting any longer as this fight continues. I never once claimed to be the strongest. I'm always striving to grow," as Zaikorn responds, "Oh, you'll see. Maybe I'm bluffing, or maybe I'm dead serious. Hard to tell, Dad? I already told you, and I'll say it again. I am the ultimate life form, not you." As it was only then during that moment where out of nowhere, Broly ended up arriving on the scene, and as he did, Gohan went on to shout, "Dad, careful! Behind you! That energy I'm sensing," Goku says. And as Goku went on to turn around, he is only then greeted by none other than Broly, as Broly went on to comment, You scum, Kakarot. "I don't believe it," Goku says. "Broly, he looks exactly how I remembered him. I never thought I'd ever see the day where he'd ever come back. Broly, listen to me. Whatever grudge you have against me can wait until this is over. If fighting me is why you are here, then I promise I will give you what you want. But as soon as Zaikorn is dealt with, I know you're angry and I know your hatred for me is unstable, but I promise, you have my word on this one. Once I finish things with Zaikorn, then I'll give you the chance to get your revenge. I know that's why you're here, but if you want to see this through with me, then you have to let me fight him." "Aw, man, just look at those two," Gohan says. "I hope Broly can hold himself together until this is over, otherwise we'll have even more problems to deal with. Wait, oh no, Dad, look out!" As that's when Zaikorn went on to catch Goku off guard by punching Goku in the face by asking, "Who do you think you're fighting here, Son Goku? Me or him? Who says you'll even live to see tomorrow, let alone giving him a rematch?" "What was that power just now?" Goku says. "I knew it. He's suppressing his real power. He's waiting for me to slip up. I can't let it happen, damn it," Goku says. And Zycor is really now beginning to put the pressure on Goku as he proceeded to throw Goku out in the distance by telling him, "Wake up, father! Have you caught on to it yet? Or do you still need me to punch you in your face for you to understand? I know you felt it. I know you can see it. Compared to my power, you will never win and you know it." And with Goku maintaining his balance by landing on his feet, he then went on to say to himself, "He's turning it up. He's a lot sharper than I imagined he'd be. Was he baiting me? Because it worked." And as soon as Zycor went on to attack Goku again, Goku has no other choice but to defend himself as Zycor went on to attack Goku by telling him, "My mother hated you for what you've done. After overpowering and destroying Frieza, she knew what she needed to do, and that was when I was born. But unlike Frieza, you will never destroy me. My genetic structure is constructed of everything you are made of, amplified hundreds of times over." And you can see the pressure that Zycor is putting on Goku just based off Goku's expression alone, as Goku went on to respond, "You're no different than anyone else we've battled throughout the years. They all came and they all went, and so will you, Zycor." "Oh," Zycor says, "and that's where you're wrong, Son Goku. You can't destroy something that's indestructible. Coward, stop hiding your true power from me and show me the power that my mother had told me about. I told you once and I will tell you again," Zycor says. "This power and this form will fail." And Zycor seriously means business, because as he went on to kick Goku out in the distance, Trunks then went on to add, "Guys, we can't just sit here and watch this. Goku needs our help. Why are we just waiting around while Zycor punishes him like this? We have to do something," as Vegeta also went on to ask, "What exactly are you looking for in him that you refuse to transform?" And Goku's really being backed into a corner here, as he then went on to say to himself, his power's picking up like crazy. This can't be his base form. There's something more to it that he isn't showing. And Goku was right, because Zycor went on to appear out of nowhere right in front of Goku by telling him, "You're not getting away that easy, father." He increased his speed even more, Goku says, because there's something very unusual going on with Zycor that Goku's trying to pick up on here, as Zycor went on to attack Goku by shouting, "Bow to me!" And as soon as Zycor connects, Goku had no other choice but to defend himself, as Gohan went on to shout, "Dad, hang in there! Don't give in! Listen, everyone, on my signal, we'll go in and you'll do nothing," Vegeta says. Look, as Zycor is shown smiling and looking down at Goku by telling him, "Yes, there it is. I knew you'd break sooner or later, and all it took was a little bit of pressure to draw more out of you." But even then, Goku went on to smile right back at Zycor by telling him, You should really pay attention." Because out of nowhere, right on the side of Zycor, a massive energy blast is shown heading in his direction, as Zycor went on to ask, "What the? How did he fire that if I didn't see him?" And as this attack went on to make contact in blowing Zycor away, Zycor quickly went on to land back on his feet and redirecting his focus towards Goku, but all of a sudden Goku was missing, as Zycor went on to shout, "Coward, where are you hiding? Where did he just go? Come out! What's that energy I'm sensing?" As lo and behold, right behind Zycor, Goku is shown transforming into Super Saiyan 4, in which as he did, Zycor was left dumbfounded as Goku went on to tell him, "Face it, Zycor, there's no need for us to continue. The longer this goes, the worse it's going to get for you. Take my advice and get off this planet while you still can. It's not worth risking your life over. This is going to be your final warning. Don't force my hand in this." Did he just? "Of course you did," Zycor says. "You tricked me so you can transform. What is this? Why does this transformation feel different than the others?" As Goku responds, "I already told you. Since I've been gone, I've enhanced each of my transformations in order to better stabilize them in battle. Now what will it be?" And Zycor's not having it, because he attempted to backhand Goku by telling him, "I don't care how many times you train, I was born with a natural power that no amount of training could help you reach, greater than anything you can ever hope to achieve." But even then, with Zycor attempting to punch Goku, Goku vanished, as Vegeta went on to respond, "Damn you, Kakarot, how did I know this was going to happen? You went and did it again, always looking to find ways to get even stronger despite being alive or dead. I can't believe it," Gohan says. "Dad, Super Saiyan 4 feels so much different than it did before. Has he mastered it? Has he mastered using Super Saiyan 4 without any effects to his body?" Because that's when out of nowhere, Super Saiyan 4 Goku went on to uppercut Zycor in the stomach by telling him, "I tried warning you. Maybe beating some sense into you will open your eyes to the truth." And that's exactly what Goku does in unleashing a barrage of punches, and as he does, Krillin then went on to comment, "Look at Goku go, you guys! That Saiyan Lab experiment doesn't have a chance. Goku Goku's hammering this one home as Majub chimes in, but then why isn't Zycor's power dropping? You would think he's getting weaker, but he's not. And as soon as Zycor is shown hitting the ground below, Gohan then went on to chime in, "Guys, I think this might be it. Zycor doesn't seem like he can take much more of this." But that's when Vegeta angrily went on to chime in, "Damn it all, it's just as I feared. There's more to him and Kakarot knows it. He now knows what he has to do and Kakarot cannot let this go on any further than this." Because Vegeta now knows that something seems to be going on, as Goku went on to tell Zycor, "This battle is nearing its end and you know it. If you wish to continue, then our next engagements will be your last. I cannot allow you to threaten the lives of my friends or any of the lives on this planet anymore. So what will it be?" As Zycor went on to stand back up by responding, "Who do you think you're talking down to like that, Son Goku? So you're a lot stronger than I gave you credit for, so what? I'll admit, you are the first person to ever hurt me like this. But now I know what needs to be done, and so I'll give you what you've been wanting to see from me. Now behold," Zycor says, "a power that far eclipses your own. A rare sight to witness." And that's when Zycor begins to hold nothing back and having to seemingly transform. And with Goku having to be shown looking on, he knew exactly what Zycor was about to do as Goku comments, "So, this is your ace card. So I was right. You were hiding a deeper level of power. What incredible power. I haven't felt anything like this before. This could become a bigger problem than I imagined. But this is what it's come to. All right, Zycor, show me your full power." And that's exactly what Zycor does, because as Zycor begins to power up and seemingly enough having to transform, the others cannot seem to believe as to what the heck is going on, as Gohan went on to ask, "Guys, what the heck is happening? I can't believe it. Zycor's power, it's going through the roof. Just what kind of power was this guy hiding?" As PyCon responds, "I've never seen anything like this before. His power is now even higher than Goku's. Damn it all," says Vegeta. "I can't believe this fool was hiding this much power from us. He was right. We couldn't have won if he was hiding this the entire time." As Trunks even went on to ask, "What's going on with Goku? Why is he just letting him transform?" As Vegeta responds, "Kakarot wants to test his power out, that's why. He knows it's the only chance he'll have. Damn them. How could they be stronger than me?" Vegeta asks. And as the dust begins to settle with everyone having to look on, that's when PyCon went on to ask, "Hey, look! What horrible power! What is that? He's far stronger than anything Super Saiyan 4 is, but how?" Vegeta asks. "Now I see," Goku responds. "What terrifying power. This isn't good. This isn't good at all." As only then, right before everyone's eyes, we then get to see how Zycor had indeed transformed into his new transformation, as he went on to ask, "Was this what you wanted to see? Well, here you are. This is the peak of my power. I am beyond your Super Saiyan 4, so far in fact, that such a form cannot be rivaled. This is your full potential unlocked. The peak of both the Kaioshin and the Saiyan. I have now become the apex of power." "The apex of power, huh?" says Goku. "Now I see why you were so sure of yourself. I've never seen or felt anything like this before. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a little nervous about this. But we'll see what the outcome will be," as Zycor went on to point at Goku by telling him, "Oh, we will. Yes, we will, Son Goku. You should feel honored, Dad. You are the first person to ever push me this far in battle before. I never expected anyone, let alone you, to push me into using this. But first you will see, and then you will die. Go ahead and think that your Super Saiyan 4 power will be enough. Because it won't." "Shall we then?" Zycor asks, as Trunks went on to comment, "Gohan, have you ever felt anything like this before?" "No, Trunks, never. What is that? How can Dad even compete with something like that?" As Vegeta went on to say to himself, he was holding back for a reason. This was his ace card. "All right, Kakarot, now unless you have something up your sleeve, now's the time to use it. If Kakarot lets this one slip on by, then he will be killed. This freak is looking to go all out now. Kakarot may need our help," Vegeta says. And as soon as Zycor and Goku then take action, Gohan then went on to comment, "If Dad isn't able to beat him, then we have no other choice than to jump in. We can't let Zycor get away with beating my dad if he does. He'll need our help if he's in danger. Everyone stand by," as Vegeta went on to respond, "Unless Kakarot can somehow match this, then I doubt he'll have a chance, but we'll see." And as soon as Goku went face to face with Zycor, he then went on to tell him, Alright then, let's do this. Show me what this power can do. And as soon as Goku then went on to throw a punch, Zycor with complete ease went on to catch Goku's punch by asking, "Oh, what happened, Son Goku? What's with the face? You don't look very pleased." And as soon as Zycor attempted to uppercut Goku in the face, Goku was lucky enough to be fast enough in moving out of the way by saying to himself, "Damn it, he's fast. I barely saw his punch coming. This is not good." As Zycor went on to tell his father, "Lucky counter, you seem uncertain now. Are you doubting yourself?" Zycor asks. What a difference, right, father? And as soon as he went on to catch Goku's kick, it was during this moment where Zycor had then gone on to swing Goku around, and as he did, he then went on to comment, "I am going to crush you, Goku, to dethrone you as the mightiest." And as quickly as Zycor went on to swing Goku's body around, he then went on to throw Goku's body up in the sky. However, Goku was in fact able to break his momentum in maintaining balance by responding, "Whoa, ah man, what crazy force. If I didn't stop myself, he would have sent me into space. Wait, what? He's gone. His speed is ridiculous. I didn't even take my eyes off of him, and he's gone. He's mimicking my movements and fighting style. Where did he go? I can't sense him anywhere." But then, with one casual elbow to the back of Goku's head, that's when Zycor went on to tell him, "Here I am, Son Goku. Did I catch you slipping?" And as soon as Goku's body then went on to hit the ground, Gohan went on to shout, "Get up, Dad! Let's see how many of these your body can endure," Zycor says. As he from there went on to fire multiple ki blasts right down into the ground, as Krillin went on to shout, "This guy is going to kill us all! Would you look at that? Watch out, everyone!" As Goku went on to dodge all of Zycor's attacks by making his way back up, and as he did, Goku knew that Zycor from here on out would be an absolute problem, as he went on to say to himself, "I have to play my cards right here. His attacks are so much stronger than it was before. I don't think he was bluffing, but I still have to try. It's hard to find an opening now that he's transformed. Wait, I think I found it. Right there," Goku says. As indeed, Goku did in fact manage to find an opening, as he proceeded to headbutt Zycor in the face by asking, "Didn't see me coming? Bet you wasn't expecting that one from me," Goku says. "Let's see if you can handle this one. Let's hope this works," Goku says. "Here goes. Times 10 Kamehameha!" In which, as Goku had then gone on to fire the times 10 Kamehameha, Zycor went on to catch the attack by responding, "This attack of yours, the Kamehameha, you think it's going to save you? This attack is like a sting to me. It won't work. This will never work," Zycor says, as he continues to push through more and more and more, until eventually enough getting within range of Goku, as even Goku couldn't believe this by responding, "No way." And with one punch to Goku's face, Goku's body went flying back, as Zycor went on to tell him, "The tides have turned, father. Now you are the one who will be punished." "His punches are heavy," Goku says. "I haven't felt shots like this before. He's probably stronger than what me and Vegeta were when we fused into Gogeta and battled Omega Shenron. Wow," Goku says. But then, before Goku's body can go flying any further, it was at that moment where Vegeta went on to step in by catching Goku's body and telling him, "Hey, damn it, Kakarot, what's going on? Watch it. Are you at your limit?" he asks. "Spill it. Can you beat him or not?" As Goku went on to respond, "To be honest, at the rate we're going in right now, I honestly don't think I can beat him like this. He's a lot stronger now than I expected him to be," as Gohan went on to join in by responding, "Then if that's the case, we'll join you, Dad. If we all use Super Saiyan 4 against him and attack him at once, there is no way he could win," as Goku responds, "It's a long shot, but it looks like it's all we can manage for now. I've yet to try something on him," Goku says, "but let's see if this works first before I try my trump card on him. We'll attack him together," as Vegeta responds, "Trump card or not, either you're using everything you have or we'll be killed. So it's better to use it now, Kakarot," as Gohan and Vegeta then proceed to transform into Super Saiyan 4. In a valiant effort to help Goku, that's when Goku went on to respond, "All right, you two, let's show him what we're made of and why we are who we are." As Zycor went on to ask, "You think 3-on-1 will do you any good? Ha! You fools are only volunteering to be killed. If Goku can't stop me, then what hope do the two of you have to stop me? Gather together as many Super Saiyan 4s as you want. In the end, you will all die. Now then, which one of you wants to go first? My blood is boiling for one of you to die." In which Goku was the first one to step back in, as he went on to then shout, "You won't do any such thing, Zycor," as Zycor asks, "Oh really? And how do you know, Son Goku? Hey Gohan, split, Vegeta says. Got it, let's go. And as the two then separated in their attempts of having to strike Zycor from each side, that's when Zycor went on to respond, look at you fools. You're so much weaker than Goku, yet you still actually believe that you have any chance of beating me even after seeing me beat him. You're both delusional, as out of nowhere through the middle, that's when Goku went on to chime in by responding, the only one who's delusional here is you. I told you not to take your eyes off me, Goku says. And with Goku then capitalizing on yet another opportunity and punching Zycor in the face, that's when Zycor went on to stumble back by responding, you fool, the only thing you're managing to accomplish here is annoying me. What good is your teamwork going to do if all of you lack the power to destroy me? So you want more proof, Zycor asks? Fine, so be it then. I am going to shred the three of you. It's my turn now. And with the others having to patiently wait and seeing what Zycor was about to do, Gohan then went on to comment, so, what do you think we should do, Dad? He's too strong for any one of us to fight head on. So what's the plan? Why don't you and Vegeta just fuse again like you did against Omega Shenron? I'm sure the two of you would smash him as Gogeta if you really tried, so what do you think? As Goku went on to respond to Gohan's plan by telling him, I don't think fusion is going to cut it, Gohan. Besides, I don't think there's any chance he'd let us pull that off on him. There's a way we can throw him off, but we need to rotate our attacks. Right now, the plan is to try and find any weak points that he may have. Exposing any one of his openings would be more than ideal in this fight. I need you to stay focused out there, or you'll die. So what do you say, Vegeta? You ready to smash your way through with me on this guy or what? As Vegeta went on to respond, you're too relaxed to be in this fight, Kakarot. You're hiding something. I know you are, but then, before any one of our heroes could execute a plan, Zycor took it upon himself in making the first move by charging on in and commenting, I'm tired of you worms whispering among yourselves. If you won't come to me, then I'll just come to you, and that's exactly what Zycor does, because Zycor's first victim was Gohan, as Zycor went on to punch Gohan in the face with Goku having to comment, look at that speed. Oh no, Gohan, these two will only be getting in our way. And with Zycor once again having to then demonstrate more of his speed, Goku went on to comment, his speed is insane. He's zipping around me and I can barely even follow his movements. Just how much power is this guy hiding? To where once again, Zycor ended up targeting Vegeta this time and punching Vegeta away by telling him, how many times must you fail before realizing your place in all of this, Vegeta? Some father you are, Zycor says. I'm going to end your life, Son Goku, and you know you can't do anything to stop me either. As Goku responds, I'm starting to think you honestly can't go through with it. If you did, then you would have killed us all by now, is that right? And as soon as Goku then went on to charge on in, he then went on to tell Zycor, so I don't buy it. You fool, Zycor says, wake up. I'm having way too much fun kicking you around this planet. As he then went on to catch Goku's punch, he then continues, it's pointless and you know it, Son Goku. And just what do you think you're going to do attacking me like this by holding on to my hand? You are getting desperate, as Goku responds, who said I was trying to attack you? I just needed to get a hold of you for just a second. And that's when Goku went on to swing Zycor around, and as he did, Zycor went on to shout, you pest, let go of me. Suit yourself then, Goku says. Have a nice ride to the bottom. And that's when Goku went on to let go by kicking Zycor directly down onto the ground. And upon doing so, Zycor quickly went on to land on his feet by having to look back up at Goku and asking, was throwing me on the floor your ultimate plan of attack? You've lost your damn mind. Use your head, Goku. Do I need to remind you twice? And as soon as Zycor then took flight, he then proceeded in headbutting Goku in the head by telling him, use your head, Son Goku. But even then, during that moment, Goku took this opportunity as he then went on to shout, ah, Vegeta, now! As out of nowhere, Vegeta came swooping on up from below and uppercutting Zycor in the stomach by telling him, know my place, huh? My place is to always be above you. I'm going to kill you, Vegeta, says Zycor. No, you won't, Gohan says, not as long as we're all together. So not only is Zycor now being ganged up on, but it looks like their plan is actually working until Zycor carried on empowering up in such a way that it resulted in Gohan and Vegeta being blown away as Zycor proceeded to shout, Saiyans! And of course, his first victim was none other than Vegeta, because as soon as Zycor charged on in, with one gigantic punch to the gut, Zycor went on to hit Vegeta by then telling him, Vegeta, you scum! Goku will be the first, but I promise, once he's dead, you're going to be next. Leave him alone, Gohan shouts. You are nothing but a coward and a fraud. But even before Gohan could do anything to strike Zycor, Zycor ended up teleporting out of the way by telling Gohan, that's rich coming from you of all people when you couldn't even save your brother Goten from dying, Gohan. And as soon as Zycor once more had demonstrated his speed feats, he went on to elbow Gohan in the spine by telling him, you'll see your brother very soon as I am done slaying our father. In which the end result for both Gohan and Vegeta was for them to revert back down to their base forms, and being shown having their bodies descend on down from the sky, and as they did, that's when Trunks went on to tell Krillin, look there, it's Gohan and my dad, they're coming in fast. We've got to help them, as PyCon responds, unless Goku has a plan or something up his sleeve, we need to get out of here and come up with something that we can use to destroy this guy. Let's hurry, Krillin! I'm not sure how much time Goku has up there, and as soon as Gohan and Vegeta come crashing on down, Krillin had agreed with Trunks in having to respond, yeah, you're right, quick, let's grab these guys and get the hell out of here, all but one, and that one person was none other than Broly, as Broly this entire time was observing the battle with Zycor and Goku and paying very close attention specifically to Goku, as Broly went on to comment, you, Kakarot, you will die by my hand, Kakarot. But even then, when going back to Goku, who was then shown having to wipe the blood from his mouth, he then went on to tell Zycor, alright, well, I've gotta admit, you are much stronger than I originally thought you would be. I don't know what this form of yours is, but for it to bully three Super Saiyan 4s the way it did is beyond impressive. I can also tell that you are slowly learning as you fight too, which means you're studying me, aren't you? I figured as well after that headbutt of yours, as Zycor went on to ask, why are you smiling? Is there something you find funny here? What exactly do you find amusing, Goku? Am I some kind of joke to you? You are on the verge of being killed, and yet you're smiling? What exactly are you up to? You should be trembling in fear. Why aren't you afraid? As Goku responds, oh no, don't get the wrong idea here. I don't find anything funny about you at all. As a matter of fact, I'm actually taking you a lot more serious than you imagine. So it's not you that I find funny. It's actually the situation. You see, after spending so much time learning and training in the Dragon Realm, I went on to stumble across something that I never would have thought would exist. And after learning more about it, I started to try and tap into it. It didn't work in my favor at first because it seemed like such an overwhelming task to achieve. But then, it finally happened. And at first it kind of scared me because I never would have dreamed to wield the power that I was. But I did. And right now, I never would have imagined that I would need to tap into this power once more in order to use it against you, Zycor. The old saying of our race holds true. A Saiyan will never stop growing and evolving himself into becoming the ultimate warrior. You may not know what that truly means because you're part Saiyan and part Kaioshin, but soon you'll understand once I show you the ultimate power that a Saiyan could ever achieve. Zycor went on to ask, what ultimate power? The only ultimate power that truly matters is the one that you are looking at right now. I am everything you could ever even dream of becoming. So spare me the nonsense of this ultimate power crap and let's finish this fight once and for all. I'm tired of listening to you Saiyans ramble on about your power. Killing my mother was a mistake that the Supreme Kai Shin will never live to regret. So since he isn't here to pay the price of what he did to my mother, then I'll just make you pay for him instead. Now what's it going to be? As Goku responds, your mother was corrupted by her own greed and failure that she dedicated her life in making sure that she was able to write off her failures by stealing my DNA and creating you. If you think you are still the strongest, then you are in for the biggest wake-up call of your life. Now let me show you firsthand, Goku says, the ultimate power of the fifth level. The fifth level, Zycor asks? What fifth level? You are at your limit and you know it, Goku. What are these lies spewing from your mouth? Quit wasting my time and let's get this over with. But with Goku then shown having to slowly power up, he then went on to comment, oh, don't you worry at all about calling it a bluff, because I'm about to show you something that was never intended to even exist. Now you stay right there and watch. And Goku means business, because as Goku then proceeded in unveiling this power to Zycor, that's when Trunks went on to comment, guys, look, The sky suddenly just got dark. Look, it's Goku with PyCon responding, so this was his ace card, was it? I had a feeling he was going to pull this out at some point during this fight against him. His ace card, Trunks asks. What are you talking about? What is Goku about to do? His power is spiking up so fast, as PyCon responds. A while back while training in the Dragon Realm, Goku had wanted to see if there was any other power that lied beyond Super Saiyan 4. It was safe to say that he found his answer towards the end of our training. It wasn't easy for him to do, and it nearly killed him. But the power that he managed to discover in the Dragon Realm was a power and level that Goku refers to as Super Saiyan 5. Super Saiyan 5? Vegeta asks. I knew it, Kakarot. As it was only right then and there where Goku began to transform, and as he did, Goku is shown transforming in such a ferocious way that he's not only going as far as to affect the landscape and the environment along with shaking the entire planet itself, but Goku is having such an effect that even Zycor went on to ask, just what is he doing? The sheer force of his power is going to destroy the galaxy. What is this? Wait a second, Zycor says. What is this? His body, it's changing. That fur of his, it's white? And his hair, it's also changing. Was he really telling the truth, Zycor asks? Could he really have discovered a new power that far exceeds my own? But that's not possible. In which we then get to see how Goku is still continuing his transformation in such a ferocious way that Zycor could not believe the transformation that Goku was going through, as he then went on to continue, I am the mightiest life form to ever live. How could he possess a power like this when I was just smashing through all three of them? Is this the true power of the Saiyan race? That vibration in the air, this energy, He wasn't lying. He really was hiding this from me the entire time. So that means, if what he says is true, no, I will still find a way to destroy him. A fifth level or not, if he could pull it off, then I can too. I must. As with everyone else having to observe this, Gohan went on to ask, have you felt anything like this, Vegeta? Just what kind of power did my dad discover? My body is trembling from the force he's putting out, as Vegeta responds, just when I thought we've reached the apex of our power, you went and did it again, Kakarot. As Goku's transformation itself is shown being so ferocious that Gohan then went on to respond, he can't go through with this transformation. He'll destroy everything, including us, if this continues. His power is disturbing the natural balance of the planets, as Vegeta responds, I always wondered if it was possible, but I never thought it would actually be real. But how did he do it, Vegeta questions. If he loses control out there, he'll destroy himself before destroying the rest of us, as even Broly went on to put this into question by asking, Kakarot, what kind of power is this? And Goku's transformation is violent, it's vicious, and we get to see the shockwaves that his body is creating in literally disturbing the natural balance of the entire universe, and with Zycor having to oversee this, he then went on to respond, it cannot be, it's just not possible. Whoa, Trunks says, just look at him up there. Goku looks unrecognizable, and that power that's emanating from his body is unreal, as Majub asks, is this truly what the power of Super Saiyan 5 feels like? As the transformation itself was complete, and Broly is in shock as well, as even Vegeta went on to comment, what massive energy! Kakarot's power feels like it's an endless black hole of energy. How did you do it? How did you manage to obtain such power without it killing you? The entire planet is shaking and he's just standing there. You clown, you leapt over me in power again. Well, now we'll get to see what this Super Saiyan 5 power can truly do. You better not take him lightly, Kakarot, Vegeta says, or it just might cost you your life. The last thing we need is for that freak to also evolve even more than what he currently is now. I must find out how he did this. I have to know. I refuse to accept my place as being your second. Not after being neck and neck with you as a Super Saiyan 4. And as we only then make our way to Zycor, Zycor seems to be staring on in absolute shock as he went on to then comment, it's complete. His energy is so much more different than it was when he was using Super Saiyan 4. So is that it? Is this what you kept bragging about when you told me about this fifth power? I'll give you credit for keeping your word about revealing this power to me, Zykor says, but the only thing it will do is extend your death sentence, not prevent it. Your cells are what run through my body, remember? So that means if you are able to reach such levels of power, then surely I can as well, as only then we get to see how Super Saiyan 5 Goku is standing there in all his glory, as he seems to be acknowledging his hand without even saying anything. That's when Zykor went on to ask, "Did this transformation cause you to go deaf? I know you can hear me, you worm. Answer me," as Goku responds, "I am well aware of what you're saying, but unfortunately for you, I don't talk to dead men. Your road of carnage ends here," as Zykor went on to laugh by responding, "Quite an interesting remark coming from a dead man himself, wouldn't you say? I've yet to use the full extent of my power against you, so don't get too ahead of yourself because there is much I've yet to show you, Son Goku." "What? You think I'm lying?" Zykor asks. "You think I'm bluffing? Or should I show you exactly what I mean?" As Goku responds, "Go ahead and try," and that's exactly what Zykor does, because as soon as Zykor then rushes in, PyCon went on to comment, "Everyone stand by! This next engagement between them is going to determine whether or not Goku still needs us in this battle or not." As even Krillin went on to chime in, "But did you guys just catch what he told Goku? What if this guy could also get stronger and find another transformation just like Goku?" "Here's the difference," Zykor says, and as soon as he attempted to punch Goku, Goku effortlessly had sidestepped out of the way and telling Zykor, "You missed." And just as cool, calm, and collected Goku was, he effortlessly then went on to uppercut Zykor so casually in the stomach that with one single punch to the gut, it had caused Zykor so much pain as he went on to spit out blood. It was only then during that moment, as Goku held his hand in, he then went on to ask, "How about it? I'm sure you felt that one. I tried warning you about this. I tried helping you take the easy way out instead of forcing me to do this. And now look at you. All this talk about being the strongest, and all it took was one punch to put you in check. So much for the strongest," Goku says, and as he went on to place his index finger on Zykor's head, he then continues, "Face it. At my current level, there is nothing that you can do that will change the outcome of this battle. You had the edge and you blew it. It never had to be this way," Goku says, as he continues to hold Zykor in place with his finger, "but you kept forcing us into a corner with no way out except through you. Are you beginning to see now?" As Zykor went on to respond, yes, of course. The only thing that I'm looking at right now is a dead man," Zykor shouts, as he then proceeded in blasting Goku from point-blank range with a tremendously powerful attack. Everyone who was watching from below was absolutely shocked, as Zykor went on to smile and responding, "So much for this fifth level nonsense. Just like you, I bet you felt that one, didn't you? You'd be lucky to still keep your face if it hasn't already melted from that attack, you scum. I have no equal. Neither you or those idiots down there could hold a candle to my power. I am you, but better, remember?" But then, that's when Zykor went on to sense Goku's power by responding, "But that can't be. I shot you from close range. Why didn't his power drop? Better yet, why isn't his power dropping? There is no way that fool was unaffected by that," as through the smoke we then get to see how indeed Super Saiyan 5 Goku was not affected by this attack, as Goku went on to tell him, "This power honestly amazes me to know that just a few moments ago, you were by far the strongest on the battlefield. You had no problem fighting against 3 Super Saiyan 4s and still holding your own, only to now face the reality of where you stand now that I've long surpassed you. Using dirty tricks like that against me won't do you any good either. I've been around long enough to know what guys like you do when you get desperate. You don't have to be what your mother intended for you to become, Zykor. You can still change, because you and I both know that if this continues the way it does, then you will surely die, but Zykor is still not letting up, because as soon as Zykor is then shown charging back at Goku by winding his fist back, he then went on to shout, "The only one that'll be dead by the end of this is going to be you." With, of course, Goku shown having to stop Zykor in catching clenching his fist in his hand by telling him, "No, Zykor, you still don't get it, do you? You just keep digging your grave deeper," and as soon as Goku then goes on the attack and moving with such speed that even the others are having a very difficult time in keeping up, as Gohan went on to comment, "Just look at Dad go, I can't see his movements," as Majub comments, "I've never seen Goku move like this before," as Goku is thrashing Zykor punch after punch. There is no letting up from Goku at all until he ended up uppercutting Zykor in the face, in which caused him to go flying up in the sky. That's when Vegeta went on to comment, "What speed! Kakarot's movements are unlike anything he was able to do in Super Saiyan 4. In which during that moment, Goku was in fact so fast that he was able to get behind Zykor and double axe handling him down onto the ground, as it was during that moment where even Krillin went on to comment, "What a shot, you guys! I think this may be it, but we need to make sure this time. We can't risk walking away knowing that this guy can come back." And as everyone continues to watch with a surprised look on their face, even Gohan went on to comment, "Come on, Dad, win this one for us. Nothing that you hope to accomplish will possibly work in your favor today," Goku says. "I can sense your spirit. You're beginning to get desperate because you know that you can't win. I've memorized your movements and your attacks, which means you can hope to attack me all you'd like, but it will do nothing for you in the end. You and I both know that this is where it ends, Zykor. I offered you a chance to walk away, and this is going to be your last chance. Do yourself a favor and leave. Get off this planet and never come back. If you refuse and you truly wish to do this, then our next battle will be your last. That I can promise. Now choose." As Zykor went on to look up by responding to Goku and telling him, "As if I would ever beg for my life. Keep dreaming, Son Goku. This isn't over by a long shot. Count your blessings, because it's only going to be a matter of time before I find a way to surpass you and transform myself. And when I do, it will be the end of all life in this universe as you know it. Where do you think you get off talking down to me like that? This form of yours may have saved you for a moment, but I'm going to tear right through you the longer this fight goes, and you know it, Goku. Time will run you down." As Trunks went on to ask, "Do you think he's right, Gohan?" "I'm not sure," Gohan says. "Does this mean that he knows that my dad will run through this new form soon?" As Goku went on to look down by responding, "You know nothing of this form, nor of any of its power for you to speak. The gateway to obtaining this strength goes far beyond anything you can even imagine, and you simply aren't there yet, nor are you ready. Do yourself the favor and leave this planet. You're fighting a losing battle." And with Zykor acting in a fit of rage, he had then gone on to once again charge back up at Goku by telling him, "Oh, I'll show you who's fighting a losing battle, you scum!" But despite Zykor's best efforts in his attempts of striking Goku, Goku went on to dodge his attacks by telling him, "It's like I told you, your anger is causing you to fight sloppy. This is barely even worth my time," Goku says. In which, as quickly as it happened, without Super Saiyan 5 Goku even having the need to touch Zykor, what Goku ended up doing was Goku simply glared at Zykor, with Zykor being attacked at all fronts, as he went on to comment, "How is he doing this? What is happening?" Which right then and there, seconds later, Goku went on to move on in by winding his fist back by telling him, "You're not doing yourself any justice. Sit down." As Goku then followed up by backhanding Zykor right down on the ground, even the others were completely surprised, as Majub comments, I've never seen Goku like this before. This is almost hard to follow. Goku isn't even touching him, and he's already making easy work of this guy," PyCon says. "Kakarot, you dog," Vegeta comments. "I shouldn't be surprised by this, but I hate to admit it. I am. But don't you worry," Vegeta continues. "I'll figure out the secrets to your power myself. Just you wait, you clown." To where, as we then make our way back to Zykor, who is then shown struggling to get up, he then went on to comment, "I don't understand. What the hell is happening? He didn't even touch me, and yet I was attacked somehow. I refuse to accept anything less than his head as my trophy." "Wait a minute," Zykor says. "Could that be his source?" As Zykor went on to notice the others, he then continues, "Could those weaklings be what's driving him to fight? To protect his friends and family? That fool has a soft spot for saving these worms. Perhaps this is what my key to winning is. If I kill them, then there will be nothing that would fuel him. I need to act fast, Zycor says. I'm getting nowhere fighting this coward like this. Mother always did say how you had a soft spot for your friends and family, Goku. I wonder what would happen if they are no longer here to aid you in battle. I will do anything and go as far as I need to in order to kill you. Kill my mother, will you, Zycor says, as he then went on to stick his arm out. He then continues, an eye for an eye. This will have enough power to blow these worms off the face of this planet. Wait a second, Goku says. What is he about to do? Is he referring to the others? In which Zycor was, and as he then proceeded to power up, Broly went on to look on by commenting, he will not be the one to end Kakarot's life. That right is reserved for me. And only me. But then, Zycor quickly followed up by unleashing a gigantic blast by then commenting, I will take everything you hold near and dear to your heart away from you, Goku. As the only other individual to act on instinct during that moment was in fact Broly, as he then channeled up enough power by transforming and commenting, I will not let you take this away from me. Kakarot is mine. As the others even went on to comment, whoa, Vegeta, do you feel that? It's Broly. Look. What is he doing? Vegeta asks. It's Kakarot. That's what's driving him. And as soon as Broly went on to charge directly at the blast, Broly then quickly went on to grab onto the blast as the others went on to comment, are you guys seeing what I'm seeing right now? Krillin asks. Did Broly just save us? What is he doing? No, he didn't, PyCon says. He saved himself. Broly only ever agreed to any of this if we granted him the chance to fight Goku again. So he wants to be the one to do it. He wants to be the one that ends Goku's life, not Zycor. That's his current motivation. In which, as Broly is shown struggling with the blast having to push him back, Broly then went on to comment, you promised me, Kakarot. I can't have you die by the hands of another. I will be the one to rip your life away. Destiny has reserved that right for me. You hear me, Kakarot? And as soon as Goku went on to look on, Goku could not believe what he was seeing. As Goku went on to comment, whoa, Broly, I can't believe it. He was actually able to stop Zycor's attack from destroying them. You, Kakarot, Broly utters. If there is anyone who is going to end your life, it's going to be me. I don't care what happens to the others. I will not die before having my revenge. Die, Kakarot! And that's when Broly went on to redirect Zycor's attack straight up at Goku, with Goku looking on in absolute amazement as he then went on to comment, yeah, now I see what Broly did. Whoever thought that this day would ever come? Well, it's now or never, Goku says. This blast is too dangerous for it to hit anything else that isn't Zycor. I believe this belongs to you, Goku says, as we then get to see how Goku raised his arms up only to knock Zycor's blast right back down at him. As Zycor went on to look up in amazement, he could not believe his eyes as to what had just happened, as Zycor went on to comment, but that can't be, no, I can't escape quick enough! Which indeed he was unable to, because as soon as Zycor's own attack went on to make contact, there was a massive explosion seen down below that literally went on to shake everything, and with everyone else shown having to shield themselves, PyCon went on to comment, what an intense attack! Goku made sure that he focused the blast at Zycor and only Zycor. Damn you, says Broly. Curse you, Kakarot. As moments later, with the blast having to dissipate as the smoke began to settle in, Trunks went on to comment, I can't see a thing out there. Did he get him? Is it over? It has to be, Gohan says. I mean, there's no way he could have survived that attack. Come on, Dad. As we only then observe within a massive crater down below, Zycor is lying face down on the ground as Vegeta went on to comment, there's no need to worry. Look closely. The day is won. The battle is over. Kakarot has overwhelmed him. There is nothing more that he could do that would change the outcome of this fight. As Krillin went on to ask, but can we be sure? What if this freak just stands back up and do what Goku did and transform again? Look at you, Goku says. It's a darn shame. And as soon as Goku ends up teleporting down below, he then went on to continue, you've made it very clear to me that there is no point of keeping you around. You are too far gone to be reasoned with, even when given the opportunity to change your ways. Your mind has been twisted by your mother, and there is only one way out of this. You and I both know what's about to happen, and you can only blame yourself for forcing me to do this. I tried helping you, yet you refused my hand. I tried talking to you, but you refused to listen. And as soon as Goku is then shown having to get into his Kamehameha position, he then went on to continue, this next attack will be my all. No matter what it is that you try and do, nothing will save you from this next attack. Kamehameha! And with Zykor shown standing back up in a very battered and bloody state, Zykor even then, after having to face such an overwhelming obstacle, could not believe that Goku was about to do this, as Zykor went on to comment, "You would really go through with this? You would really go through by killing your son, Goku? What kind of man would accept this as being the only option? No, I don't buy it, Zykor. May." And Goku is not letting up. He's not looking to give in, let alone even speak to Zykor. And Zykor now knows this as he tries to make a run for it and commenting, no, wait, you can't. Damn it all. I have to find a way to escape and heal. I won't let this be the end. But right before Zykor manages to go any further, Goku then went on to shout, "The nightmare ends now, Zykor." As it was only then, right then and there, during that moment, Goku had then gone on in firing off this gigantic Kamehameha. Zykor cannot believe it, as Zykor went on to comment, no, how could this be? This cannot possibly be happening. How is he able to keep this up? I won't let you, Son Goku, you hear me? I am you. I can adapt just like you. And so what Zykor does is he then goes on to grab onto Goku's Kamehameha, and then having to continue, "I will send it back. I must. I am stronger," Zykor shouts. "I am everything you are, so I can't fall to you. I am the superior life form. I won't fall," Zykor keeps uttering. "I will also achieve another form, just like you." And with Goku still shown pushing, he then went on to respond, "As if I would ever allow for you to do that. You had your chance and now it's over. Someone like you is too dangerous to keep around. You've caused too much pain," Goku says, as Zykor is shown losing ground. Goku then continues, "And you won't stop here. You could have been so much more than this," Goku says. "No more, Zykor," Goku shouts. "No more! Someone like you is too dangerous to keep around." And Zykor now is completely overwhelmed, as he then went on to respond, "Curse you! Where is he getting this power from? How? No, I won't fail," Zykor says. "Son Goku, I won't fail." "Damn it, Kakarot," says Vegeta, "finish him now. Don't let him get the chance to evolve. Finish this fight now. He cannot be kept around any longer. He's part Saiyan, which means he could get even stronger if he survives. End him now, Kakarot," Vegeta shouts. As even Gohan went on to chime in by telling Vegeta, "I don't think Zykor is going to overcome this. Look, Vegeta, he's losing ground. Come on, Dad, finish this once and for all." And with Goku doing exactly that, right before delivering the final blow, that's when Goku went on to tell him, "Your ego and blinded hatred for me has led you down this path. You had so much potential," Goku says, "to do great things. But instead, you wasted your potential on doing the wrong things. I cannot allow for you to hurt any more people ever again." As it was only then, right then and there, during that moment, Goku went on to shout full power, and as he did, there was absolutely nothing that Zykor could have done to overcome this Kamehameha, but instead, Super Saiyan 5 Goku's Kamehameha had then completely overtaken him, as Zykor went on to respond, "Impossible! Impossible! I am the ultimate being! How could I fall like this, Mother? You lied. He was stronger than you told me. He was stronger," Zykor shouts. I can't, Father, Son Goku!" And right then and there, this was the end. Goku had then managed in putting everything he could into this Kamehameha, in literally blowing Zykor not only into outer space, but into billions of pieces, in completely eradicating him with no trace of him left. By the end, the only thing that was shown was Zykor's silhouette, with a massive crater having to be shown formed following the Kamehameha, and as it was, Goku was shown having to stand in overlooking the crater by commenting, "You were out of this world powerful, Zykor. You had so much potential to turn your life around and not be anything like your mother wanted you to ultimately be. I wish it never came down to this, but It's finally over. Dad! Dad, you did it! Gohan shouts. As everyone then began to make their way towards Goku, Gohan quickly went on to hug his dad and not wasting a single second by telling him, "This power of yours, it's insane! How and when did you discover it? I never would have imagined that there would be a power beyond Super Saiyan 4. I didn't think there was either, Gohan, but I'll explain more about this power later on." As even Krillin and Majin went on to comment, "You had us worried there for a moment, Goku. It's good to finally have you back with us. You really are everything they said you were," says Majin. "Welcome back. It took you long enough, Kakarot. So this is what Super Saiyan 5 is, huh? I knew you were up to something while you were away. So tell me, is this it? Is this the peak of your Saiyan power?" "Vegeta," Goku says. "Well, to be honest with you, I'm really not sure. I haven't really gotten around mastering this form yet, but the only way to truly know is to master it first and see where it takes me." "Is that so?" Vegeta says. "Now I see. So it's obtainable after all," with Goku responding, "I think you can achieve it too, Vegeta, but by no means will it be easy to do. It's tricky, but you'll know when you're close once your body begins to react to its power. It took me months to find it," with Vegeta responding, "Well, I hope you now know what I'm going to be training for. I'm not going to let you slip past me and be the only Saiyan to wield Super Saiyan 5. So it's only going to be a matter of time." "Well, suit yourself, Vegeta," Goku says. "I'll be here when you get it." But then, that's when Broly went on to step forward in uttering Goku's name, and as he did, he then went on to comment, "Kakarot, you, Kakarot, I didn't forget. You know why I'm here," Broly says. "Broly, yeah, I didn't forget about why you're here. I know what you want, and I told you that I'm going to give it to you once this was done," as Broly went on to respond, "You will die today, Kakarot, by my hands." "It doesn't surprise me that you want me dead, Broly," Goku says, "and by now I thought you'd already catch on. We aren't the same. I'm not the same as you remember me by. I don't mind giving you a rematch, but you and I both know that you can't win. I am far stronger than anything you are, so this wouldn't be much of a battle if you're weaker. I'm sorry, but you won't win. We don't need to do this, but if you insist that we do this, then so be it. But just so you know, if we do this, then I won't be holding back against you." And as soon as Broly overhears this, he seems to be getting angrier the more Goku is talking, as Broly went on to respond, "You could never rival my power, Kakarot. I am the legendary Super Saiyan. I am the one who possesses the greatest power of our Saiyan people." As it was only right there where Broly did not waste any time in wanting to get his rematch, so what he proceeded on doing was punching Goku in the face, and as he did, he then went on to tell him, "You will die, Kakarot! I will destroy you!" "Whoa," Gohan says, "Broly really wants to do this. Dad didn't even flinch." "Broly's completely lost," and Trunks responds. "Is Goku really going to fight him?" "Well, Broly certainly does," PyCon utters, "but look, Goku seems a little reserved because everyone is looking at this with complete confusion, as even with Broly's fist lodged into Goku's face, Goku did not feel a thing," as he went on to then ask, "Are you starting to see it?" "I told you, Broly, there's only one outcome, and that's you'll lose." And as soon as Goku grabs onto Broly's hand in removing it from his face, he then continues, "You have a lot of potential, Broly. It would be a shame if you came back only to be destroyed without putting up a proper fight. It wouldn't be worth it, would it? I'm sure that deep down you want this to be the fight of your life, don't you? To see that you were able to beat me at my best while you are at your best as well, right?" And with Broly taken back by this, Goku then continues, "Well, since you now know, this is going to be your last chance, Broly. Leave this planet and don't come back until you're ready. Leave this planet and don't come back until you're ready. It would be a shame if I killed you now. So leave and go train, and when you are ready, I'll be here waiting. Don't be foolish and let this pass you by," Goku says. "Take this opportunity and leave." As even with Goku turning his back to Broly and looking over his shoulder, he then went on to tell him, "I know you'll be back, and I can't wait to see how powerful you'll become when you return. You can still change, Broly. I want you to remember this day. I hope you're smart enough to see that. In the end, it will be me and you. Just the way you want it to be." And with Goku then shown stepping forward towards his friends, he then went on to tell them, "And with that being said, let's go home, everyone. Let's stop by the lookout before anything else. Everyone gather. "Remember my offer, Broly," Goku says, as he then places his fingers on his forehead. He then continues, "Leave and don't come back until you are ready. Now then, let's go home, everyone." And with everyone having to vanish, Broly is left in utter confusion as he then went on to utter, What? Kakarot, Kakarot, you? I will have my day, Kakarot. I swear I will. This form they've obtained. What is that? I will surpass all of you, Broly says. As a silhouette is shown in the background, he then continues, I will make that power mine. In which, as Broly then began to power up, in taking Goku's advice, he then went on to continue, I will rip you apart, Kakarot. You are dead. I will come back. I will return stronger than ever. And as soon as Broly then goes on to take his leave, in exiting planet Earth, he then continues, stronger than you can ever imagine. Stronger than all of you. I will level this planet of yours, and I will have your head, Kakarot. I will not fail like I did before. You will regret this day. You will perish. This white-haired Super Saiyan form. You won't be the only one to have it, Kakarot. Yes, I will make it mine as well. I will go beyond anything you imagined I'd be, and then, only then, you will die. As only then, the Beyond Dragon Ball AF story of Zycor versus the Z Fighters then comes to a close. Now, it has been many years since the original creator Toible, aka Toyotaro, who is now currently working on Dragon Ball Super, have ever either considered in going back and continuing the story of Dragon Ball AF or perhaps even rebooting it, but at the same time, since nothing was ever being done involving the concept of Zycor, I wanted to go on ahead and tell my own story by picking things up exactly where Toible had left off Dragon Ball AF, with Zycor having to break free from the Z Sword and having all of the Z Fighters, including Gohan and Vegeta, all gathered together in their attempts of stopping Zycor. But at the same time, I really wanted to encompass the overall narrative by introducing a brand new transformation, because I had a feeling that Toyotaro had hinted in introducing Super Saiyan 5 way back when, nearly 20 plus years ago. So I wanted to go on ahead and follow through with the inspiration of keeping Super Saiyan 5 Goku a thing in Dragon Ball AF and concluding the entire narrative involving said characters by having Goku finally be the one to put Zycor down. However, at the same time, I've often wondered what exactly Toible was thinking about when bringing back Broly, so I went along to keep Broly alive in the end, because I do actually have a few ideas for him and a few projects in mind involving the AF concept of Broly, so it's actually awe-inspiring to see how much of an impact Dragon Ball AF left within the Dragon Ball community, even till this day after so many years of hiatus, that in all honesty, I really don't ever see Toyotaro, aka Toible, ever coming back to either finish Dragon Ball AF or perhaps even maybe even rebooting it if he wants to do that once he's finished with Dragon Ball Super. And I think that the only way Toible would ever come back in doing Dragon Ball AF is when essentially enough Dragon Ball Super is finished, because I'm pretty sure that Toyotaro since then is very sharp. He had improved so much so, and I really can't wait to see what lies ahead, because for all we know, Dragon Ball AF one day may in fact actually continue, or from what we originally had from Toible spanning from chapters 1 to 5, with 5 being the rough draft, it actually might be all we get from him, to that only time will really tell. So in the comment section below, what I want to know from you guys are three specific things, that being number 1, do you see Toible ever actually going back in continuing Dragon Ball AF? Question number 2 is, how strong do you guys believe a hypothetical Super Zycor or even Super Saiyan 5 Goku would be, by of course comparison to Dragon Ball Super characters? And lastly, what kind of story do you guys want us to tell involving the concept of AF Broly? So once again, I do appreciate your time. I do want to thank you guys so much for being here. As of course, as always, if you just so happen to be new to this channel and have a love and passion for Dragon Ball, then I do encourage you guys to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications by clicking on the bell icon to never miss a single video posted onto the channel, as well as also give this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys enjoyed. Tune back in for more. Thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for being here in this experience, in reliving and ultimately recreating the story of Dragon Ball AF, and there is so much more coming down the pipeline that I can't wait to show you guys. So thank you all so much for being here, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you down the comment section below and in the next video. Take it easy, guys, and have a great day. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network, which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life and taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so very much for your support, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes, but Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Freezer.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm a real gaming! But once you get video, I'll lots of likes, or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Vados, get over here! Tell these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Engine gaming fan! This is my moment! I'm a part of his notification squad! Universe 7 can have all the fun! I just want the food!
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video! Show some love for the best community on YouTube!
Kakarota!